All right, ladies and gents, welcome back to some more of the most consistent career mode, I would say, on the YouTube platform, but you guys can have your debate over that. It is the Manchester United career mode, and we're in quite a good position for once. We're not in any I'm panicking, I don't know what's going to happen kind of positions. We're in a good sort of stance right now. In the league, we're in a good spot because we're in fourth, only 5 points behind the league leaders, which are Manchester City, who just they won't stop winning. They never stop winning. Which is quite annoying, but hopefully they will at some point, and we can try and get into a title race. I know my ultimate or my primary goal this season was top four, just to make up for the disappointment from last season where we didn't get a top four. But if we can go that one step further and get the Premier League title, I wouldn't be opposed to that at all. I don't think we will be able to win it, if I'm being like straight up honest, but there is a possibility. We've scored about the same amount as the big boys. In fact, we're the highest scoring team in the Premier League. Defence is a bit leaky, but it's coming around. The defence is fine. It's just the goalkeeping sometimes is a bit questionable. But the same goal difference as the top two as well. So it's doable. It is doable. We just need to string a good load of results together and hope that Man City will slip up somewhere because they're still undefeated. Who do they play next? Spurs. Oh, well, there you go. They've lost. That's fine. But then we have to think about Liverpool and West Ham as well. With all the teams around us, first and seventh. Well, the first down to eighth is still quite a good battle. Maybe Newcastle's slightly out of it now, but still a close run thing at the top. At the relegation zone to kick off this episode as well. In the relegation zone, I should say, and Norwich, Leeds, and Watford. Will those three be the same teams who end there in the relegation zone this episode? Who knows? Looking at the Europa League as well, we managed to finish off our Europa League qualifying group with 18 points. Because it was a piss easy group, and it was like playing against bloody toddlers, mate. It was piss easy, and we've now got the preliminary round where eight of these teams will advance to the round of 16, and we will figure out who that is or who those teams are once those matches have been played. Now, I would like to play against Rangers personally. It'd be a cool little match that, but I have a horrible feeling we're gonna get like Inter or Dortmund or something. So we shall see on that front. And then today's schedule, I believe we have the Carabao Cup game finally against Spurs. We do. That's going to be the big hitter for today. So kicking off today's episode, we'll be taking Brighton on at Old Trafford, which will be a tough game because Brighton are a bit difficult to play against. Not to mention it's the first game of the stream. And I always do bad in the first game of the stream. So I'm not surprised if we don't get full points there, but I'm going to try. Then we take on Spurs in the quarterfinals of the Carabao Cup. Away at their stadium once again. We've had a trip to their stadium this season, lost 2-1, so I'm hoping it's not a repeat performance from us there. We then take on Watford away at Vicarage Road. They're bottom of the league, so it should be a win, but you just never know. And Crystal Palace will end the episode. Once again, we will be hosting them. And then for season 2, episode 9, we'll be moving into January and hopefully maybe considering some signings. I don't know if I'll definitely sign anyone just yet. But any ideas will be put onto a shortlist, and I will maybe pick a couple. So, taking a look now at the squad, well, the news actually. Bear with me, guys. I haven't read the chat yet. Sorry, chat. I completely forgot. The treble is ours. I bloody hope so. Imagine. That's what the board want, and I wouldn't be too mad with it. Hi, Cameron. Sorry, I haven't been in the streams late as I have been training with Real Madrid Academy. If so, that's crazy. Fair play to you if you're training with Real Madrid Academy. That's fantastic. By the way, I scouted South Africa for players on my youth squad. Have found from the. So I thought it'd be cool. I have no joke, found eight players named Tshabalala. I'm going to keep going until I have a whole starting 11 of Tshabalalas. Madness. Yeah, Tshabalala. The name pool for South Africa doesn't seem to be too big. I've done a career mode off screen where I've also scouted South Africa. And the name pool doesn't seem to be too big. But we've got the only Tshabalala we'll ever need, really. And he will be the man to carry us to victory. So anyway, look at the news now. Abraham hits hat-trick in Man United win. He's a scam. Abraham scored a thriller hat-trick to overwhelm woeful Leicester City at Manchester United's 4-1 win. Player of the Year announced. It was given to Mohamed Salah. Mohamed Salah winning the Ballon d'Or. I can't disagree with it. Some of his performances last year in this career mode were fantastic. And it's probably the right choice. And stunning displays from Tammy Abraham. He gets a little interview segment here, and he's happy with how he's going. I'm happy with how he's going. Pundits and fans alike have been powering over the displays they've seen from Tammy Abraham lately. He's been one of the outstanding performers in each of Manchester United's recent games and is looking like the man to watch every time he steps onto the pitch. Now, we take on Brighton up next. I think I'm going to rotate a little bit for this. It's a battle between two of the clubs and the pursuing pack as Manchester United host Brighton and Hove Albion in the league. The 3 points look vital to both as they attempt to close the gap on the teams above them at the top of the table. Brighton and Hove Albion know that only a win will do for them as they play catch-up. Manchester United, meanwhile, know that a point would be a bad result, but they'll be chasing victory nonetheless. We should see a positive Open Game of Football. A point would be a bad result, if I'm being straight up honest, because Brighton are, I believe, 16th or 17th or very low in the table anyway. So, yeah, 16th. I would be upset with just a point. One of them is white. Don't know how that's happened. He's bloody pale. Yeah, I don't understand. But it's all right. Ultimately, I was intentional. All right, I'm not fully ready to go yet. I've not been feeling well over the weekend, so kind of just try to recover. So also for the transfer hub, we've got a couple of players who we still have on here for potentially down the line. But at the moment, I'm not going to sign any of them, but the main one, if I was to sign someone, would probably be Zambo and Gisa from Napoli. This was suggested by Reese, and he's got such good all-round stats, and he actually seems like quite a competent CDM/centre-mid, so you could always have him to buff up the centre-mid area. He could also play CDM, but he'd play that behind Casemiro, which means we'd have to maybe move McTominay or Fred on as well. So there's a possibility we go for Zambo and Gisa. We're still looking at De Kuyper, who is slowly growing, but I don't think he'll be this season signing. Maybe in the summer. I don't know. We'll see. And then we've obviously got the left-back options. Owen Vindahl as well as George Bello, just in case. But I need to really update this shortlist. So if anyone's got any ideas, more than welcome to suggest them. I'll have a look around myself, scout around. But I don't think we really need too much just yet. We maybe need another centre-back. But I think we'll be all right. He's white with dreads. Feels a bit racist. Can't lie. He ain't moving mad. Reese is a football genius. Yeah, no, that Zambo and Gisa one is a decent one. But I want to keep the faith in McTominay, to be honest with you, a bit more. I think Zambo and Gisa might be a summer move, potentially. Because I do like McTominay. And I know that's an unpopular opinion, but I actually do like McTominay. At least on FIFA, anyway. Maybe not in real life, but at least on FIFA. He's quite fun to use. And as much as I would like to move on Fred, I think moving on Fred and selling him on would probably result in a kind of mutiny in the chat and on the YouTube channel, so I think we have to keep him around as well. So I think for now, we'll keep it till the end of the season, maybe. Potentially move on Ericsson. Did Ericsson go down in overall? Oh no, he's 84 still. There's a slight chance we move on Ericsson as well. It might be a bit of a clear out in the summer. We'll see what we can do there. But anyway, we've got Brighton first. I'm going to get into it because you came here for the gameplay, not for the talking. So we'll get that sorted. We'll get the team rotated a bit. Vega and Afif are good signings. Vega. There's a few Vegas. I'm trying to think what Vega you mean. I will put him on the list. I know Afif from the World Cup. I think he's a good little talent, isn't he? Akram, Afif. I don't know if he'll be at Man United's level, but I will take a look. And Vega. Which Vega is it? There's a lot of Vegas. Is it? There's two that I think it could be. It could either be Alexis Vega, who I know is okay on this game, and I will scout. Or it could be Pedro de la Vega, who is also very good. But I will I'll put them both on the list. Alexis Vega. Okay, I won't put them both on the list then. Yeah, Alexis Vega's not too shabby. I've seen him in other career modes. He actually does grow quite well. We'll keep an eye. Moving on Fred absolutely shattered my heart and I wouldn't be able to move on with my life. Exactly. That's why I don't know if moving on Fred would be the most sensible of options. But the Vega, that's the start of a free agent at the start. He's at a club now. He's at Lazio. If I'd known at the start he was a free agent. Well, to be fair, we are 1.5 seasons deep now, so we're a bit ahead of that curve. Right, so we're going to go the one striker, actually, because Abraham is tired and Rashford is in form. We'll have Sesko on the bench and probably rest Abraham for the Spurs game. Tshabalala will also be rested for the Spurs game. He'll probably come on as a sub in that one. We're going to give McTominay a start. Now, this is kind of a proving match for him because we do have Zambo and Gisa potentially on the incoming arrivals. We'll see what happens with that. We're also going to give another Premier League start to Lafont. I know he just had the Leicester run, but I want to see what he can do again. And we'll probably give De Gea the Spurs game, obviously, so that's why we're doing that. So we'll give Lafont another try. I think that's how we go. The only other one I would think is Kvaratskhelia for Sancho, but I'm not 100% behind that. Luke Shaw could come in from Malasia, because we need Malasia top form for Spurs. And I would bring in Wan-Bissaka. Do we bring in Laird? Do we bring in Laird for this one? Just to rest Dalot for Spurs. We'll at least maybe have him on the bench. But maybe a Laird bring-in could be an option. Fred could come onto the bench for Šeško, and we'll swap them like that. The Vega lad, that's a free agent to start, yeah. I think I got the right one. I hope I got the right one. The McTominay bias from the gaffer is unbelievable. It's like Maguire with Ole all over again. Realistically, all right, I've barely used McTominay over Casemiro. It's only Europe and some games I've used him. I've used Fred. I've probably used Fred more than McTominay, I think. We'd be good to get some Premier League minutes. We'll put Laird in then, and I think that's how we'll go for this one. A bit of a rotated lineup. Not fully rotated, because we do still have Spurs, obviously. We need to think about them. But we do have this game, and Brighton can be a struggle sometimes, especially with Mikel Antonio up front. They've got a good midfield with Caicedo and Gross, and we don't want to talk about Pascal Gross. Made our lives hell at the start of the season in real life. Tariq Lamptey as well, Seema off the right, Stupinian off the left. We've got a good amount of young players, but we're going to go in with this squad and see what we can do. Lafont in goal, Sean Laird as the fullbacks, Martinez and Bella Kotchap as the centre-backs, McTominay, CDM, Fernandez and Eriksen as the centre-midfield partnership. With Fernandez captaining the side, I've got hiccups. Kvaratskhelia off the left, Antony off the right, and he needs to start having some good episodes sooner. I'm going to get really annoyed. And Rashford as well up top, who I know has had some good episodes. But this man right here, it's not playing like these stats suggest, and I want a bit more from him. And maybe it's just me being bad at the game, but I just don't feel like he's been as good this season as he has last season. So we'll hopefully get something from him. And we're going to get into it. We're about 12 minutes in, and we still not haven't got into a game yet. Usually in by about 10 minutes. Too much talking, not enough playing. Now, I would very much like to get the 3 points out of this, but as we've seen in previous streams, previous episodes, the first game on always seems to be a bit of a struggle for me. Obviously, because I'm just starting the day. First game of the day and all that. But at the same time, against Brighton as well makes it even worse, because even though they're 16th, they've still got some talents. So we're just going to have to figure it out as we go, I think. An early goal would be nice. You can play off of that. No offence to Lafont, but I think I trust De Gea more against Spurs, even though he did concede the two that meant we lost to Spurs earlier. I still think I trust De Gea a bit more. At the moment, I might change down the line, but at the moment, De Gea's got more of my trust. But taking a look at that side, some of them are tired, and we're going to have to take advantage of the stamina problems that Brighton have got, and the fact that they're not rotating their team too much, I think. We have to try and... I think it was Lewis Dunk that was more the tired one. Brighton have signed Seamus Coleman. That's an interesting one. We've got some decent signings and decent bench. But Seamus Coleman is not someone I expect to see at Brighton. But neither is Mikel Antonio, to be fair. So again, proving game really for McTominay. As well as Antony needing to come back into form. Bruno I would have suggested as well. But to what? Well, I mean, at the start of last episode he was good. Towards the end, it was kind of more of a Tshabalala show, and Bruno didn't really get a look in. So I think Bruno's probably back safe again, at least for now. Personally, I would say, anyway. Don't know if it would be agreed on. But Brighton try to go early. The speed here. Luke Shaw coming across to deny that. And now we need to just... We just need to outplay him, really. Because Brighton are more a team that's... Well, the way they've built, it seems like they rely a bit on pace. Well, we just need to rely on pace as well from Antony here, who's going to run straight to Stupinian. Does win the ball back. And the ball back over to our number 21. Can he play it inside to Marcus Rashford? One more to Bruno. It's blocked. Rashford is saved. Antony is blocked again. It's still come to Anthony though. Eriksen! Oh, man. Well, what a cluster is the word I was looking for. Cluster chances to kick off this video game. If only I knew what I was trying to say, these episodes would be a lot more smooth. Anthony, towards Rashford. He's headed the way. Only as far as Kvaratskhelia. Into McTominay. It's blocked again. What's up, Sobol? Welcome to the stream. Not my cab. Hashtag Tshabalala better. I mean, he is better, but he's also very tired, which is why I've not used him today. He might get some time in the Spurs game. Eriksen to deliver. Towards Bruno. Maybe not the move. Kvaratskhelia. Bella Kotchap! Oh, it's blocked. Laird, can he win that? He does. We're keeping the attacking pressure on. And there's a foul somewhere. I don't know what happened there. I'm assuming Laird got caught, would be my assumption, but it's a free kick to us anyway. I'm doing all right. Been a bit unwell the past couple of days, so I'm just trying to not be. I was really sick. I don't know why. I was really sick on Sunday, and it's kind of not really gone yet, but hopefully it will do. I don't think it's serious. Anthony. Kvaratskhelia. Blocked again. Brav. Corners are so dead this year, I swear. I feel like I can deliver them well. It's just try to find someone in the middle because it always goes to the wrong person. Maybe I should go to more of the receiver than the corner taker. And I always go the outswinging corners. Maybe I should just try on him with Eriksen, see if it goes any better. I'm going to try this one with Eriksen. See if there's a better result from it. Rashford, no, it's just too many. There's too many tall Brighton players as well, which doesn't help. Rashford, try to spot McTominay, but, like, realistically, what would McTominay have done if he got it? Like, missed the shot? Nice. Sorry, I need to have faith in my midfield. Martinez gets that to Laird, and Jesus Christ! Antonio's up for this, by the way, in case you're wondering. My man Laird hasn't played a lot of Premier League football, and Antonio comes into him like that. Jesus. Into Eriksen. We are big possession hoggers in this team. Oh, ref. I mean, I don't really know if that's a foul, but I'm very upset that Rashford's done that, and I want the ball, please. But yeah, we're big possession merchants at this club. Just try to find the right ball through rather than counter-attacking, which I might not usually do. I'm a bit different like that. I used to be, like, counter-attacking, but it never seemed to really work. Antonio comes close for Brighton there. Not the greatest of opportunity. Well, it was a great opportunity. It's not the greatest of attempts. I should have closed it down a little quicker, to be fair. Not to blame myself if that does go in. But Antonio bottling that one. And Brighton could have had a lead. After all the attacking pressure, we started with, it could have gone to Brighton. Nah, what do we do down the right? We need to try and involve Anthony a bit more. And I always seem to go closer to the camera with these winger runners as well. I don't know what's so enticing about the camera being on me. Eriksen. Tomine. Attempted to get it back to Eriksen, but it was a good read. An equally good read by Martinez, and that might open up something here. Bruno, just too many defensive Brighton players. I can't seem to get around them. Maybe somebody like a Fred, or Van de Beek. Obviously, he's on low, but Van de Beek might work today. But Fred, we've got Fred on the bench in case we need a miracle. Laird reads that perfectly. I don't know what their left wing was thinking there. Anthony's not going to get there. Laird does, though. Laird's had a good game so far. Tried to slide there. It didn't slide. Pascal Gross trying to get into the middle to Antonio. McTominay in a bit of trouble. Just hoof it, mate. Oh, you've got to be kidding me, man. How have I tried to clear it and it's gone there? We're panicking a little bit. I'm not going to lie. Bit of panic coming on. Good again by Laird. Fucking hell, they're up for this, aren't they? Lafont tries to find Eriksen. The pressing like nobody's business. Can you bugger off just a second? Give me room. We're finally like broken out. West Ham to take the lead over Chelsea. That's the one thing I didn't want. I'd rather Chelsea win that one. Anthony, he's an option. Does get the option. It's blocked. That was great wing play by Anthony in the end. Got at Skelia to Shaw. Tries to spot Anthony. He's not very tall. Eriksen. Bruno. That's poor touch from Bruno. Jesus Christ. Brighton, that fucking pressing bit with Brighton, I thought honestly we'd fucked it. Lukshaw gets the ball there, and we should get it away. Belkocap to Leecher. My God. Anthony. McTominay. Bruno. Tries one. Straight to the hands of Sanchez. McTominay won't score here. Fred and Tshabalala would on the brace right now. Yeah. I mean, I probably should have started Fred, but Tshabalala is exhausted from the Leicester game, so the reason he's not in the squad today. He will get... I'll put him at least in the squad. I don't know if I'll start, but I'll put him at least in the squad for the Spurs game. Anthony to Rashford. God damn it. Brighton have showed up today. This is what I mean. They're very good. We just haven't been able to break them yet. McTominay wins that header. Gets it all the way back to Shaw. It's still in our possession. We've had a lot of the ball and a lot of chances. We just haven't been able to put one away. And then Brighton have like been pressing us as well. We've been very strong in defence. I'll give us credit where credit's due. Got it, Scalia. Yeah. Rashford. McTominay. Eriksen making the move. Can he find the ball into Rashford? He can. God damn it, Sanchez. Sanchez is a ridiculous goalkeeper. We should have brought him in. We were thinking about bringing him in. We ended up bringing Lafont in. Sorry, Tshabalala's exhausted. My bad. All right. That's a bit sus from you. Eriksen, put it a bit further this time. Okay. That's why I use the outswingers as well, because if I use the inswingers, it goes too close to the keeper. I should have just whacked that with Anthony. Okay. Laird gets it on to our number 21. We've been the better team, but bloody hell have Brighton been fighting us for it. They're making sure we don't score today. Towards Eriksen from Laird. Anthony, win that back. No, that's not what... Okay. That's not what I meant. We'll win the ball and keep it. Laird close it down again. I fucking love Ethan Laird, man. If I do move on a right back, either Wan-Bissaka or Dalo, which it probably will be Dalo. Maybe not even Wan-Bissaka, but either way, Laird's got a place in this team, is my point. Kvaratskhelia. Oh, didn't spill to Rashford. And it is 0-0 at the break. Laflop as backup keeper looking a bit sus. Yeah, I don't know if you can call him Laflop, because he's been all right. What's up, Franco? Welcome to the stream. But Sanchez has kept us out today, and maybe we should have had Sanchez instead of Lafon. But we can't call him Laflop, because most of the Europa League campaign, he only conceded 2 out of the 6 games, and that's fucking son. That's incredible. Take a look at the half-time scores then. West Ham drawing 1-1 with Chelsea. Come on, Chelsea, I'm pulling for you in that one, mainly because it would slow West Ham down. But we also need to find a goal here at Old Trafford. 0-0 between Burnley and Norwich as well. And a match facts check will show that we are all over them. But they've been fighting us for it. They've been keeping us out. I'm just a hater, mate. It's been solid, to be fair. Yeah, I know you're a hater. You hate Makoko. You call him Abra scam as well. It's just... You just don't like my players. It's fine. 67-33 in terms of possession. 11 shots to 1. 1.9 expected to go 0.2. And 92 passes as well. We've got double their passes. We've been all over them. But it is just absolutely ridiculous how they keep me out here so far. Sanchez with a good string of saves. But can they keep us out for the second half? If we can get a goal off the rip here, taken by surprise. If Kvaratskhelia could just run through and score here, that'd be mad, mate, please. Right, maybe more than that. I need help. Can you please give me a good centre back and a backup goalie for Chelsea? I have 228 million. If you have that much money, it shouldn't be too difficult. Let me give me a couple of minutes, I think, and I will get back to you. Goalkeeper, there's a guy from Valencia called Mamar Dashvili. He's only like 76 rated, I think, but he's got good potential, and he'll grow into a good backup keeper, and maybe even a good main keeper down the line. Centre back's a bit more difficult to think of, but just get Maguire in, honestly. In all seriousness, for a centre-back, maybe a Pau Torres, perhaps. Or Gvardiol. Yeah, Gvardiol. If you're looking for a main centre-back, would be Gvardiol. Right. Let's figure this out then, because Brighton have kept us at bay, and I don't know what needs to change, really. But it's not that we haven't been creating chances, we haven't been finishing them off. And I'm wondering if a striker change might be the move. Anthony, mate. Oh, bastard. Oh, they're coming now, Brighton. They're going to be better in the second half as well. They're going to think they can go for it now. Martinez cracking tackle to deny Antonio. They're going to try and go for it now because it kept us quiet first half. Goes to the corner. Hopefully we can get this away without any issue. Eriksen should win that. And it goes back to the Brighton player, but it's an easy catch for Lafont. I think in the games we've had Lafont, I mean, yes, he's been good and he hasn't conceded a lot of goals, but for the most part, he hasn't had a lot to do in the games in the Europa League because we've just been so dominant. Leicester, he was good, but that goal that went in from Leicester, I mean, he couldn't do much about that. It's just finding the time to give him without making De Gea upset, because I do love De Gea and he's cracking in FIFA. But we should be able to give Lafont some more games, some maybe Europa League knockout games. Shot through to Rashford. Oh, man. Oh, no, Rashford. Oh, I couldn't switch to Rashford. Sanchez nearly kicked it into his defender. That could have been a disaster there if I'd actually been aware of it. I don't know how I'm meant to expect that, though. Fernandez. Anthony. In off the side. Anthony! Oh, what? Like, nah, genuinely. We're bringing him on. We're bringing on Fred. We're also going to make some other changes, I think. But we're bringing on Fred is the main one. A bit more energy needed. I wonder if Sancho makes a move on. Kvaratskhelia hasn't filled me with a lot of confidence today. And neither is Antony, to be honest. We're going to do it for Antony. No, we're not. We're going to do it for Kvaratskhelia. I think Antony still has something to offer. I think that's how we go. Fred and Antony for now. We'll maybe bring on Makoko. But I think Rashford's probably our best source of goals. I think Gvardiol has the most pace out of the ones we suggested. He starts around 80, I think. If you want pace, go for Lacroix. He's got fucking bags of pace and he grows quite well. Fred towards Martinez. Bruno. Sancho. Oh, just fight for it. Jesus Christ. If we get a goalless draw here, Brighton have been full value for it. They've been class at stopping us. But Bruno. Oh, it's like, mate. You are Bruno Fernandes, 88 rated captain of Manchester United. And that's what you pull out your ass. Sanchez has been ridiculous today. Oh, man. Fernandes to Sancho. Oh, try to find a way through. We can find a way through, we just can't find the finish. Antony, please. Oh, just go away. Sanchez. I can't wait till he, like, get sold somewhere else. Well, I'm going to buy him just so we don't have to worry about this, Brighton. All right, Fred, good corner, mate. Come on, big from you. Towards Rashford. Nope. Sancho. Oh, it's a heavy touch. Oh, it's not going to fall for him. I wanted to do a shot off the edge of the box, but it didn't fall. Oh, mate. I don't know what to change. I guess we go attacking. Probably the best change we can make. I thought we could do enough for balance, but pushing a bit further forward might have to be the thing now. Even if it does leave space at the back, it's the only issue I can think about with this. It's already left space at the back. For a second I thought Lafont might have fucked that with his positioning, but he holds on quite well. Antony, he's dropping deep for some reason. Does it move my players around? It's sort of Antony and Sancho. Right. 17 minutes to find someone here. Fred into Sancho. Out to Ethan Laird, who's been classed today. Except for, I mean, I commentator's curse, isn't it? I say he's done well. He passes it straight to them. He wins it back. Gives it into Antony. On to Fred. Sancho. Can he get on one more to Rashford? Please. Oh, just. Honestly, fair play, Sanchez. You've done me good today. You've done me good. If they go and steal a win now, like, I will be very annoyed. but I can't say Sanchez doesn't deserve it at least. Rashi. Oh, there it is! About damn time. It's about damn time. The breakthrough has finally come around. And Marcus Rashford with 12 minutes to go. But it's a stupid goal, but I don't care because it is a goal. And it also means I can rest Rashford now. That's the one that Sanchez doesn't save. That's such an awful shot. That's not the shot I wanted to do at all either. But I don't care. It's from the back of the net. You could do it. Yeah, Man United career mode's always fun. It's painful, but you get there in the end. Creator Club is quite a fun one as well. 11 and 16 for Marcus Rashford. He's popping off this season, and it's a goal for him. He's going to make way for Mokoko now. I'm going to sit back a little bit, back to balanced. Back to balanced now, I think. As we've got 12 minutes left. Can you sign Paul Smythe? He plays the best team ever. Does he? I'm guessing he plays for Leighton Orient, for a start. Try and hold on here. Bellicott chap. Fred. Oh, right. Antonio just ballooning it over from Brighton. They will push for the equaliser now that they very much deserve. Oh, man. 8 minutes left for us to hold on here. And I didn't think this would be as much of a grind as it has been, but it has. Is that McTominay making the run? Why is it locked onto not McTominay then? I mean, it did lock onto McTominay, but it didn't go the way I wanted. Martinez has been a fucking stallion at the back, by the way. Big up, Martinez. Martinez and Laird, my favourite players today. Obviously, Rashford got the goal, but offensively, they've been class. Mokoko! I don't know why I shot it from there. I thought he was going to go to McTominay and he tried a long shot, actually. But it's locked into Mokoko instead. So, slowed down there by Shaw. We might just have to take the one goal win here, which is fine. A win's a win. Sancho. Oh, fuck's sake. I tried to slide. Sometimes it doesn't slide when you press the X button. I've noticed that. Maybe it's just, I don't know, me. Might just be me. Imagine if they get a late equaliser, I'll cry. I was joking. Nice Bellicott chap. Get it away. I was joking. Don't actually score a late equaliser. Mokoko heads up. It was meant for Anthony, but it's made me go Fred. 4 minutes. I don't know where he's pulling out of his ass from, but okay. Interesting. Ball's barely been off the pitch. Bellicott chap to Bruno. Like, I'm not even joking anymore. Bruno, he's passing his wank, and I don't know why. All that matters is we hold on, though, Anthony. Keeps it on. Fred. Oh. Shit. Where's Laird? Laird push forward. While we try to defend. Solly March tries one. And that will do it. Oh, man. Oh, do I have a Discord? I have Discord, but I don't have a server. If there was enough... If I had enough viewers, then, yeah, I'd fully go for making a server, but... I need to wait until there's a bigger channel, really, before I start making a server. But 1-0 victory for Manchester United. It was a grind. The goal that we got was poor. But honestly, Robert Sanchez, a little unlucky there for his team. I don't care. A win's a win. We take that. Brighton, thankfully, poor at shooting. And we get away with it as well a little bit because they could have gone for a late equaliser. But we did dominate, and if it wasn't for Sanchez, it could have been a lot of goals to go in there. 62-38 turns possession, 20 shots to 7, 3.6 expected goals to 1.8, and as much as we deserved it, I feel a bit bad for their goalkeeper in the end. Ultimately, I'm surprised he's not the man of the match. How long are you streaming for? I play 4 games each stream, so it should be about, by the end it'll be about 2 to 2.5 hours, so probably around another 2 hours ish I would still be streaming for, I reckon. Lissandro Martinez getting man of the match. He was one of my picks to get man of the match as well. Defensively sound as usual. And maybe he has a shout at becoming the next captain down the line, because Bruno is not doing well with the armband, although somehow he got an assist. But Martinez, 8.4. Luke Shaw, 8.3. He was someone I rotated in the last second to rest Malasia, and it was a good choice. Anthony, 8.2. I mean, he was better today, but I don't think he was as good as he could have been. As in, like, he has better in him, but it was a decent performance. Laird, I think, deserved a bit more. 7.8 for him, but I think he deserved a bit more. He kept that left side completely silent. Bella Kotchap has proved to be a good little rotational centre-back as well. Marcus Rashford with a goal and a 7.6 in the assist. Coming from Bruno Fernandes with a 6.7. I keep shit-talking the boy because he can't make a pass. But then he also goes and gets the assist for the only goal, so I don't really know. But man of the match for Brighton, I disagree with this, but Moises Caicedo getting the man of the match award, 7.6 for him. Tariq Lamptey as well, 7.5. But I think Robert Sanchez, who only got 7.5, probably should have been the man of the match. 12 shots on target, 11 saves, 1 conceded. And the 1 conceded wasn't even that good, so maybe, arguably, should have had a clean sheet today. But fuck it, I don't think anyone else is better than Sanchez on that pitch today. I'm the winning team. Let's get to the post-match interview. Chelsea did beat West Ham. Come on. Come on, Chelsea. I can't believe I'm cheering for Chelsea. Do I play as my old manager, Ten Hag? I play as my old manager. It's a manager I've used for previous career modes. He's kind of a cult hero on this channel at this point. If you're a long-term viewer of the channel, it's called Theo Johnson, yeah. He dresses like a bloody guru, a fashion guru. We gave ourselves something to hang on to. That's what matters. But yeah, the YouTube channel link is there. Thank you for that, Jordan. I know, but like, it was meant to be an easy win, but they really didn't make it easy. We had the chances to win by more, but Sanchez was something. But we do end up with the win. It was difficult to get through, and when we did, Sanchez was annoying as well. I think Sanchez won the match, but talking about Caicedo, who is decent, we were able to graft today. We just had to, it was more, sometimes you get class displays from us, which is just like fluent passing, brilliant finishing, and a great result. Today was more of that scrappy mentality where we had to just go for whatever we could, and we got it, thankfully. So where's that, does that put us up any higher on the table? I mean, what, see, oh, it's a quarter final next, alright, okay, but West Ham lost. We're up to third now. City lost. Oh, I was joking when I said Spurs were going to win. Lads, title race is on. Title race is on. I'm not going to lie. We're looking fantastic for it. City finally defeated. The undefeated finally comes to an end. West Ham dropping out of top four. Spurs did win, though. That was a bit of a problem. But at the same time, we do have better goal difference. I don't want to say it too early. We're only halfway through the season, but title might be there if we can keep consistent. Up next, it will be the game against Spurs in the Carabao Cup. I'm just trying to think. When I'm talking slowly, I'm trying to think. I've dropped a sub on the YouTube channel. Thank you, Franco. I appreciate it. So take a look at the quarterfinals. Some have been played. Preston will make it to the semi-final. That's an interesting one. It'd be good to get them if we get past Spurs. Newcastle are through over Burnley. Liverpool will probably beat Luton, but fingers crossed is a shock there. And then hopefully we can get past Spurs, but we've lost them once already this season. Chats coming in from the players. Rafa Varane is fit again, boss, but I hope I've done enough to stay in the side. It's a big moment for my career. I know what you can do. Varane wants back in as well. I think I'm going to go Martinez-Varane, obviously, but we'll have Lindelof on the bench. They do have a decent side at this point in career mode. Orban's an interesting one, but otherwise, it's actually not too bad from them. We're going to go two-striker with Sesko and Abraham, two tall boys. They were hopefully just going to fucking cross into over and over again. All these VODs, if you miss any of the VODs, you're missing the action within the actual episode. All these go up on the channel. I'm just trying to think of what to do here. I want to use Varane, but Lindelof also wants a game. Where is Varane? He's down here. All right. So we'll do this. Bella Kotchap can have a full rest. Varane How's Martinez? Martinez is, what is his stamina now? He's a machine. Dalot, Malacia, De Gea, Casemiro, Anthony. Do I go with Alanga here? Or even Diallo. Fernandez is exhausted, which means I think you know who's going in there. It's the first time I've tried him in the system. I don't know if Fred's gonna be involved, unfortunately, because of this formation that I'm gonna use for this one. We're gonna go to two striker for this one, but just because I'll put Fred on the bench, because why not, innit? Fred can have a spot on the bench. I don't think he'll come on this game. We'll give Alanga a try over Anthony. Anthony will stay on the bench because we might need a bit of pace towards the end to run at tired legs. We'll keep Rashford on the bench because he can always surprise with a goal. Wan-Bissaka could come in there. I think that's how we go for this one. Fred at striker equals prime CR7. Oh, imagine. Let's take a look at the team today. Then we've got De Gea. Oh, hold on. This man thinks he could just take the armband. It goes to De Gea. All right. De Gea in goal as captain. Malacia and Dalot as the fullbacks. Martinez and Varane at centre back. Casemiro, CDM. Sancho left mid. Alanga right mid. The biggest risk of the day. Tshabalala at cam. Up front, we've got Sesko and Abraham. So this is the first time I've used Tshabalala in this system. And that's the main thing I'm scared of. Because he works well in the other system. But in this one, he is the only attacking availability. We'll have him on free roam, though. And we'll see what he can do against Spurs, who are, I think, using their best squad. They might have rotated a couple, actually. We're using our best squad. We want to beat Spurs, all right? Or most of our best squad. I could probably rotate a little bit more, but we're going for it because we want revenge against Spurs as well. The 4-1-3-2 is what we're using. I'm going to play 4-2-3-1. 4-2-3-1 is equally as good. But I love the wingers too much. Although I suppose with the 4-2-3-1, you can also use wingers, but I also like sometimes having two strikers just to support each other. This is what we're trying today. I think we used one striker in the last time we went on against Spurs, so we're going to try it this way. He's going to prove you wrong like he's done all bloody season, my number seven. I believe in him. He's just, I don't know. Spurs might be a step too high for him. Right. While this is loading up, I'm going to get a drink, so bear with me. Now, if I remember correctly, the last time we took on Spurs, there was one man who really turned it around for Spurs after he came off the bench. And he's on the bench again today. And it was Richarlison who got a brace past us to have Spurs beat us at this stadium last time around. And he's on the bench again, so super sub Richarlison is something we need to watch out for again. But we've got revenge on our minds. And we're going for it. A trophy as well. Getting the Carabao Cup would be nice. Obviously, the least important of the four trophies we compete for. But it would be nice to have. Alanga. Sesko. Try to find Tammy early. Sesko's going to take a shot at himself. Oh, imagine. Tammy very upset that the ball didn't come through to him, and I will have upset the ball didn't come through to him as well. Richarlison put on put a direct tackle as well. I've got to flatten him if he comes on. Yeah, Richarlison gets the will get the Varane treatment, the Casemiro treatment maybe actually, and Varane treatment would be too nice. We win it back just about. They're using Jed Spence. This can't be Conte still in charge. Good cover by Martinez. Bounced off Sancho. Kane trying to get back. Kane dropping very deep, which we know he does, but like, still. Cesco also dropping deep for us. Sancho. Tammy. As Tshabalala there. To attempt a shot. It's blocked on that occasion by Tomori. Now, that's a problem. Malasia's there, has the pace advantage over Kane. That's cracking tracking from Tyrell Malasia. And now he's going to make the move forward. I don't know if it was a foul, but it's not also not what I want to do with my left back, Tammy, in his debut. I'm sick of this. He's been here a year, all right? I can't believe... It still pains me that they forgot his hat-trick on his actual debut. Sancho, I'm just going to try and get short to my... I'm going to do a 1-2 here, hopefully. That's the plan. Thank you. Play it in. And one more. And Tshabalala! Oh, good save. Is it your recent goal or is it Pickford? I forgot. By the way, it's a good save. Sancho to swing this one in. Towards... Rafa Varane, he's not going to win the header. I think it's Lloris. Yeah, it's Lloris in goal. Malasia falls to Casemiro. We don't get the strength battle one there. What the hell? Casemiro's as strong as anyone. I've got so much confidence in Malasia, man. He's too fast. Don't commit Varane out there. God damn. That'd be a silly manoeuvre. I've committed Varane too far. Oh, shit. Thank God Varane got back. I didn't even mean to commit him there. It just kind of happened. Block initially from Martinez and then again from Varane. Means it rolls to De Gea and we can get moving again. Alanga to Tammy. Oh, just get shut down. Varane. Oh, cracking. Have that, Son. Harry Kane closed down by Leicha. I don't think I'm exaggerating when I say I think Martinez is probably the best defender I've used in FIFA. He's just good. Just very, very good. Oh, Cesco, you've tripped over the ball. Dalo, Alanga. He's been on and off this season, mostly on though, to be fair to him. Casemiro! Oh, there's the Casemiro screamer! We were wondering when it was going to happen, and it's come in the Carabao Cup against Tottenham Hotspur. The Casemiro corker from about 30 yards once again. Opinions on this team. De Gea, Dalo, Varane, Martinez, Shaw, Casemiro, X, and Anthony Fernandez, Sancho, Rashford. It's a fun team to use. It's a fun team to use. I would probably use Malasia over Shaw just for the pace aspect, but that's a fun team. Man United's default team this year is cracked, which is why I don't want to change it too much. That's why I've only done like minor changes so far. Did Tshabalala get the assist? I'm guessing. But Casemiro. Casemiro with the fucking goal. First goal of the season, I believe, from him. And it had to be that. An instant equaliser attempted there by Son. Couldn't close him down. But the save from David De Gea at his near post prevents an instant Spurs equaliser. Antonio Conte is still in charge. So why they're using Jed Spence is beyond me. Because Spurs don't use Spence. They've sent him out alone to Ren in real life. Thomas Lamar's probably going to play it short to Son. But we're going to try and close it down. Alanga's overcommitted there. Dalo, I thought I won the ball back with him. Good save from De Gea. And now they're reversing it is the word I was looking for. Son to Lamar this time, probably. On this one. Casemiro blocks it. We're trying to just concentrate here and get away. It's a good save again from De Gea. I don't know what sign to make. The first person I signed in career mode was a striker, because realistically we've not got enough striker options in the game because Ronaldo left and we've only got Rashford and Martial. And in my career mode, of course, it got a 7-month injury to Martial, so I had to just sign an emergency striker. But I mean, the striker's got to be something you have to sign first off, and I learned that the hard way. But yeah, if you're looking for a backup striker, Sesko's not a bad option. Sesko's quite fun. I'm trying to think of people who aren't in my career mode. Vlahovic, well, no, he's more of a main striker. I'm trying to think. Who could be a good backup striker? De Gea saves again at his near post. Backup striker. You can always sign Richarlison. He's causing me nightmares in career mode. He might be fun to use. Never actually used him. A backup centre-back I would recommend is... I was going to sign this guy called Lukeba, but I didn't get the correct fee for him. So I signed Bella Kotchap. Those are a couple of good backup centre-backs as well. But I don't want to give too many of my players away, because then it wouldn't be an original career mode. I'll try to think who else would work. Midfield is probably okay. Wingers are probably okay. You may need another left mid, potentially. Because you do have Garnacho and you do have Sancho. Maybe a backup left mid. Sell it, put Garnacho on loan and maybe get a backup left mid, perhaps. And for that, I would suggest... Who would I suggest? I don't know. I wouldn't say he's a backup left mid, but I suggest maybe try and Ansu Fati. Apparently, he's really fun to use in career mode. I try to think about... When I try to sign people, I usually just think of main players. I don't really... have backups on my mind. This is why I've asked for a lot of help for some of them this year. Because of Mokoko, Sesko, Kvaratskhelia. I think Kvaratskhelia was my idea, but Mokoko and Sesko, I think I would have suggested them. Alanga to Sesko. Towards Tammy. Oh, the header. Oh, the header! I thought the header was shit, but then Lloris dropped it and nearly fell to us again. Casemiro trying to win the ball back. Spurs have been value for it today. They are rivaling the top four race as well. Same points as us in the Premier League. We're above them on goal difference, to be fair. Just off a win against undefeated Manchester City. So they've got all the momentum in the world. I didn't think about it that way. Varane can't keep that in. Garnacho's gone on loan. Yeah, Garnacho needs... What I learned the hard way is Garnacho needs a loan. And he's on loan this year and he's grown fucking fantastically so far. Good save from De Gea again. De Gea has been put to work in this match. What I've realised is it makes De Gea look worse, because he does sometimes concede more goals, but also he's making a hell of a lot more saves. So I still trust De Gea for now. That's poor from me. Somehow it's not gone in. Somehow Spurs haven't taken advantage of my mistake there. We're trying counter, but it's not going to work. Just getting the ball away, really. Spurs are already back. They're already defending. And it's weird to have play against the Spurs with a competent defence, because usually you play against Spurs and they're shit. Tshabalala. Been quite quiet today from him, but again, I thought this might be a step too high. He does have the assist for the Casemiro goal. I couldn't remember who did it, but Jordan tells me, and I believe Jordan more than anyone. Tammy's hit the post. It could have been two. Should say I believe Jordan more than anyone when it comes to Tshabalala, because The biggest number one Tshabalala simp. De Gea's had a really good first half. I'm just hoping he can continue it because it's going to be a grind in the second half. These games have not been easy so far today. I'll tell you that much. Oh, Casemiro, you... please, ref, thank you. I was going to say, if you don't fucking blow the whistle... Ibra scam. Oh, mate, it could have been two for us. It could have been one for Tottenham. It could have been multiple for Tottenham. The fact that it's only 1-0 is a bit of a shock, but it's Casemiro who's got the Casemiro screamer, that regular thing. It's not as good as the ones he got last year, but it's definitely still a very good goal. So I'm not really... I thought I'm complaining about a very good goal. Liverpool only 1-0 up, you know. Luton have possibilities there to get back into it. So I'm saying. Something could happen there. Liverpool 1-0 up at Anfield. We're 1-0 up at the Tottenham Hotspur Stadium. So far, we know Newcastle and Preston North End, of all teams, have made it through. Spurs been slightly better, the game says, and I probably would agree, to be honest. 63-37 in terms of possession. 8 shots to 6. 1.1 expected goals each, but we've been riding our luck a little bit with De Gea. Was it Tshabalala who got the assist? All right, what was that? Fair play, Tshabalala. What a man. What a lad. Second half. 45 minutes to go. Will we reach the Carabao Cup semi-finals? And if so, who will we face? Hopefully the answer is Preston, but I don't know. Alanga's been a little quiet today as well. I'll try and bring him in more second half. Tried to knock it back there. We'll get a throw though. If we can get a good start to the second half, that'd be fantastic. Dalot. Being marked by Heung-Min Son here. Casemiro. Alanga. In Tatami. Tshabalala. Try to find another option. Casemiro from the edge again. It wasn't going in because it was on his weak foot. I knew that one. Let's see if we could do what it did against Forrest in real life and get a brace. Varane closes down Son. Cesco didn't want to join me. Did you... I think what I bid around about, I think I bid around like 8 million or something. So if you've gone below that, then he might not. Or if he just, if sometimes the club can't sell him because they don't have enough options in that position or something. So it's really what, I don't know. But yeah, for me, I think it was 8.5. De Gea again, man. Class Mew. He's also corrected me dirty. Yeah, of course I did. He's banging ass in every formation. Yeah. That's why, because he didn't have enough depth. Yeah, sometimes it's annoying. I mean, I've got Makoko as well, but I don't know if you want to steal Makoko as well. I'm trying to think. Who else? I mean, I'm doing this thing where I don't sign players from Big Six teams. But if you want to sign players from Big Six teams, Amanda Breuer from Chelsea might be a move. I'm trying to stay away from the Big Six, just trying to keep it as competitive as possible. How's that... Sorry, no. How's that gone through to Gonzalez then? Good job by Varane to close it down. Eddie. Is that Nketiah? Another good shout, to be fair. Oh, could Tshabalala get there? Not quite. He's gone in for it, to be fair. You've got to respect the heart shown by the number 7. I can't remember if I left Eriksen on the bench. If I did, we're going to bring him on very soon for probably Tshabalala. But Tshabalala, you know, he's got his big minutes. I'm playing him a lot more than anyone else would play a 55-rated player at his level, to be fair. If you're watching any other career mode, there is nobody who's using a 55-rated player consistently in a Man United career mode. We've got Watford at Vicarage Road next. I'm hoping for... Well, I say I'm hoping for a win there. It's got to be a win there. They're bottom. And we're going for the title, hopefully. I'm not going to say we're going for the title until we are at least even on points. Or at least... like we're only 3 points behind the others, but... I don't want to say we're in the title race yet. The Marcus Edwards shout is quite a good shout as well, yeah. And Nketiah grows quite well. I'm trying to think who else you need for backup. I think that's probably your set. You've got Maguire and Lindelof as backup. You've got Varane and Martinez as Centre backs. You've got Malacia and Shaw. You've got Wan-Bissaka and Dalot. You've got plenty of midfielders. You only really need a backup striker. Or a back, and if you want a backup left mid, yeah, Marcus Edwards is a good shout. We're just trying to find the second. I think the second goal is going to be key here, because this is exactly what happened in the league. We didn't find a second goal. They went and bagged two. Just wait for the Richarlison substitution. To be honest, we should be making some changes too at some point. I think that's what we're going to do now while the ball's out of play. Try to sell Harry Maguire. Fair enough. Maguire's a weird one. I do like Maguire in career mode, but that's purely just based on his tackling. In real life, he's absolutely wank. And I'm going to make a fucking choice here, and this is going to be an absolutely mental one. I'm picking Fred as CDM. Don't ask why. Maguire's pace sucks, but I'd keep him for the tackling. That's like crashing through players with Maguire. I have sold him now. I sold him in the summer to Southampton, I believe it was. I swapped him for Bella Kotchap. But first season was quite fun to use. I was just trying not to... I like the first season, trying not to take too many players out of the squad and then building from that. It'll change over time, probably. Sancho, try to find Cesco in the middle. It's still only 1-0. I'm a bit concerned. Lindelof wins a header. Fred for Lindelof. It seems a bit of a bittersweet substitution there where I'm bringing Tshabalala off and Fred on, but too much of both of them is not a good thing. Oh, fuck. It's been coming. It's been coming. It's more of a when than an if. Bring on Anthony. Harry Kane equalises for Tottenham Hotspur. I don't know what our defence was doing that wide open. Kane just had to tap it around De Gea, and it's a great finish. Fred going on at CDM already has shown that we need bloody Casemiro. Tshabalala gets taken off, and look what happened. No, it's because Fred came on. Definitely because Fred came on. 1-1 now, and Spurs will feel like they can go for this again. This is what happened in the bloody league. They equalised and they went on to win. We need some magic now. Anthony coming on, running at tired legs, was the move I was planning on a while back. We've made that move now. I really hope they're not a bogey team this year. Fucking annoying. Martinez, great. And he's going to push forward as well. He wants this more than anyone. Cesco asking for it. I'm so dog shit at this game. That was such a bad pass. Malassi picks it up though. Sancho. Cesco. Eriksen against his former club. Got to try and play it back to Fred. Eriksen can't find Anthony. Gonzalez. Closed down by Malacia. We might have to go to penalties. Does it still go to penalties in the quarterfinals? Can someone research that for me? Because I don't remember. Carabao Cup quarterfinals, does it go to penalties? Oh, Richarlison's on. Right, nah, guys. Snap the cunt. Oh, I missed. Martinez gets it away to Sancho. Get it, keep it away from Richarlison. Jesus Christ. Oh, fuck. De Gea. Oh, my God. I thought for a second he fucked it. I'd fucked it. Heart and mouth. Spurs are giving me issues this year. Last season, they were crap. Anthony, pass that on your right foot, mate. I know it's a weak foot, but please. In that situation, just do it. Oh, my God. This isn't the Tottenham I know and love. The Tottenham I know and love would bottle this. 2 minutes of added time. Good save again from De Gea. I'm not trusting this game. I'm not trusting me to try and go for a counter there. It's penalties straight off. Oh, man. Sebak options are Shaw, Lindelof, Verano, Martinez. It's good depth, to be fair. You can switch Luke Shaw between centre-back and left-back as well.
First game of the season versus Man City. Yeah, beat Man City, please. That would make me happy. Right. I'm kind of glad I brought Tshabalala off now because his penalties are probably dog water. Take a look at that. Spurs do deserve it. I can't even lie. If they win, I'm not even... Well, I am going to be mad because I've lost, but I'm not going to be mad in terms of who deserves it. 56-44 in terms of possession. 14 shots to 7. 2.2 expected goals to 1.1. The only reason we're still in this is called David De Gea. He's been mad. Fred's going to bag it. I really hope so. Take a look at the penalty takers. Do I put Fred on 5th? In fact, I'm putting Fred on Francesco. I don't trust Francesco at this level. Tammy, Sancho, Eriksen, Fred, Anthony. I wish I had some more penalty takers on, but I didn't know we were going to go penalties. Harry Kane has 92, by the way. And Spurs will take first. Harry Kane versus David De Gea. It's a save! Tammy now. And Lloris saves as well. Oh, man. Richarlison. David De Gea. Sancho. Bags. Thomas Lamar. De Gea again. Eriksen against his former club. It's a penalty of dreams. Heung-min Son to finish this for Tottenham. Will he score? I will. Who? Oh my God, it comes down to Fred. It comes down to Fred. It's Fred for Manchester United. And it's Fred that puts us through. We advance to the Carabao Cup semi-finals. All the credit in the world to David De Gea. Two penalty saves. Was it three? Three penalty saves, I think. But Fred is the man who scores the deciding penalty. You can write this shit, man. And here it is again. But David De Gea... if anyone was doubting his ability, David De Gea has proved all the fucking haters wrong, I tell you that much. Oh my God, Fred is the man that has got us past Spurs. You gotta be kidding me. Never gonna hear the end of it now. Oh, mate. What a penalty shootout. Man of the match is absolutely De Gea. And if anyone ever speaks shit on his name again, I'll have to deal with me, all right? My God. It came down to penalties. I didn't think it would. I hoped it wouldn't. We've somehow got through. We've somehow made it through, kept our nerve. Once again, those stats, if you didn't think that we deserved it, you'd be right. We didn't deserve it. 56-44 in terms of possession for Spurs. 14 shots to 7. 2.2 expected goals to 1.1. Double the expected goals. Double the shots. Spurs were definitely the better team today. We've got away with that. Man of the match, I think, doesn't go to the... You know what, fine. I'm going to say a 2-2 draw because Man City aren't easy to beat on FIFA. But I do believe... I hope you win it. But I'm going to say 2-2 for your prediction, Franco. Casemiro with the only goal for us today. 7.7 and a goal. But how... Could someone explain to me how this man hasn't got man of the match? Could someone explain to me how he's only a 7.3? Because I need a calculator, a protractor, all kinds of equipment to decipher why he hasn't got man of the match. My man made 9 saves out of 10 shots on target. Conceded 1, yes, to Harry Kane in the main game, yes. Spurs did deserve a goal, but that's beside the point. He's just saved 3 penalties in the penalty shootout as well. I don't understand ratings. I'll never understand them. Tshabalala with the assist for the Casemiro goal, 6.1. Didn't really light up too much, but he did get the assist, which ultimately was important. Man the match goes to... I just don't understand this video game. Could someone explain to me how this works? Son gets man of the match. Not even Harry Kane, the guy who scored the equaliser. Not even De Gea, who was ridiculous. Son. 8.2 for him anyway. It's not that I hate Son, I just hate the rating system. Harry Kane gets the equaliser, what was the equaliser before the penalties. 7.5 for him. Nico Gonzalez with the assist. And I want to kind of take a look at some of the Spurs ratings here and see what's changed for him. Pavard 82, Reguilon 82. Richarlison's 83. That Dane Scarlett, I'm surprised he's not out on loan. They still have Ndombele, that's a bit of a shock. Christian Romero didn't start, maybe a mistake. Pickford didn't start, maybe also a mistake. Tshabalala assists, and friend sends us through. My boys, I'm coming for your job, mate. Nah, come on. I am going to watch that go back from Casemiro, though, just real quick, because it's a Casemiro screamer. You can't pass it up. It was Tshabalala who knocked it through, but the Casemiro screamer, it's a thing every year. You've got to have at least one Casemiro screamer. And it was a beautiful finish. And it was enough. I mean, I thought it might be enough for us to win the whole match. But they did equalise. And it was nervy stuff, but we got through. Don't forget that Abraham missed the penalty. He did. What a bastard. Luton didn't get back into the game, just for the record. So it will be Liverpool that also advance to the semi-finals. And knowing us, it'll be them we get. I would love a game against Preston, but watch it be Liverpool. But also, yes, I wouldn't mind it being Newcastle, actually, because they knocked us out of the Carabao Cup last year. So a bit of revenge there would be good, too. Abraham also hit the post as well, but I didn't want to talk about that. Well, we've got some penalty drama. Spices up the episode a little bit. We got there in the end. We didn't even deserve the result. I feel a bit bad for Spurs, but then again, Spurs are always going to bottle trophies, so we're just in the right place at the right time. Honestly, I wanted to win it, but the way that Spurs came at us, I actually expected to lose. I actually expected Spurs to go through. De Gea was a fucking machine. Son is very good, yeah, but I mean, he wasn't man of the match today. Well, what a good start to this episode. A win over Brighton, putting us higher in the table into a title race. And in a semi-final match against Spurs, Varane has reached his potential of 85, which I'm putting partly on the injury he had. I reckon he could have gone to 86, maybe even higher, if he'd not had the injury. He won't grow much more. We'll put him on this because it's the quickest one. But that's fine. Varane is just a tank at the back anyway. He doesn't need to grow in rating. 1-0 to City, Haaland penned. Ah, fuck, that's unlucky. I believe, though. I believe you'll win. Even though I said 2-2 draw, I still hope you win because it's Man City. Thanks for pushing me back into action at last. I felt ready. It was the right decision, wasn't it? It went to plan for sure. And Lindelof should be happy as well because we did give him minutes in that one towards the end. Thanks for all the first team chances I've been getting, boss. I'll keep doing whatever I need to. I mean, you... yeah, you've been doing really well. I'm still proud of you, mate. That all comes in every so often saying, oh, thanks, mate. And I'm like, yeah, no problem. And about 3 weeks later, it's like, yeah, thanks, mate. And I'm like, yeah, no problem. It's just like a revolving door. Northern Ireland want us. We're going to decline that. I'm pretty sure they're coming for us already as well. I think the only job we'll probably take is the England job. And even then, I don't know if I'll take that because I kind of want to just focus on Premier League at the moment. That's how the table's looking. Watford have 6 points. Have they even won a game this season? They've won once. And they've lost 14 out of 18. If we don't win this, if we don't get 3 points out of this game, I'm upset. Just quite frankly, I'm very upset. Because, again, they're bottom of the league. And we've just come off a semi-final against Liverpool. Actually, or semi-final against Spurs. Let's see who we've got. I bet you it is Liverpool. Now I mentioned them. What are the bets? Who have we got in the Carabao Cup semi-final? I'm hoping it's Preston. Obviously, for ease of getting to the final. I would like it to be Newcastle for a measure of revenge from last year as well. But I can guarantee you it'll be Liverpool. All right. I'll take that. Measure of revenge, it will be, hopefully, at St. James's Park. I will take Newcastle. But it does mean if we do win, we'll most likely face Liverpool in the final. But my God, if Preston make it, that would be a fucking cracking story for them. But those are the semi-finals for the Carabao Cup. And it could come full circle for us versus Newcastle. But up next, it is Watford. We'll get the pre-match conference done. Team's not made a great start. I mean, we're only 3 points off the top. So I think we've made a really good start, to be honest. And we're not even halfway. This is a halfway point of the season, so double our points, and that's what we'll end on. So if we win today, we'll be on 40, and then you double that. That's what points we'll end on. Wan-Bissaka has been good in form. Yeah, I'm going to give him a game today, to be honest. I think we'll give Wan-Bissaka a run out. Because we had Laird, and then we had Dowell. And we look stronger than Watford. If we... Let me put it this way, media. If we don't win this, I'm going to be very upset. You can never be sure, I suppose. Fabrizio Romano announced breaking. Manchester United have started construction on a statue to commemorate Fred's legendary penalty goal. It'll be done by the end of the season and be put on display for the start of next season. Fair enough. My United went on pens after astonishing drama, and it's Fred in the picture as well. Fuck's sake. They don't remember Tammy Abraham's debut, but they'll remember Fred's penalty. Haaland is a machine, man. He's so difficult to defend against. He scored 2 past me in this season as well. Carabao Cup review. Spurs versus Manchester United. Manchester United were eventually victorious over Spurs in yesterday's match, which ended 1-1 and was decided only after Manchester United won 3-1 on penalties. And the tie between Tottenham Hotspur and Manchester United went to penalties. We know that. The Manchester United players showed more composure in the final moments of the game before managing to beat Tottenham Hotspur 3-1 in a thrilling penalty shootout. And I'd be remiss to say that obviously it was Fred that got the winning penalty. Varane is back and ready to make his mark again at Man United. Manchester United are delighted to see Varane back in action. A great performance from him today means expectations for our team are sky high. And then we take on Watford today, of course, in Premier League action. 3rd versus 20th. Realistically, if we drop points here, I might have to end the episode early because I'm going to be very upset with myself. We've got another Dallow thing here. Unless that was the one that was already up here. Oh no, this is from the Spurs game. Manchester United have a I've read this before with Dallow, and it's the exact same writing, I think. But we'll read it again. Manchester United have a happy player on their hands, Diogo Dallow. The right back is very satisfied with how much playing time he's getting, and he says he can't even imagine what's playing anywhere else. Yes, it's true that I'm enjoying my football at Manchester United. I have a good relationship with Johnson. He seems to recognise my value to this team, and I'll do my best to try to repay his performance, or repay out trust with good performances to help us move forward. He beamed. All right. Watford. They don't have a bad team. And when I say that, I mean, there's players I recognise. The team is quite... I see where they've got 6 points. Okay. We'll go one striker for this, I think. I feel like a one striker move here, and I don't want to use Abraham after his performance against... Spurs there. Abraham was one of the few players that was poor in that game. We're going to give Martinez a rest. And we're going to go Bellicoc up Varane for today. Dallow will get a rest. Wan-Bissaka will move on. Bring on Shaw as well. He was good against Brighton. I want to see him again. I know Malassi was good there, but I want to see Shaw play again. So we're doing that. Casemiro stays in. Eriksen stays in. Fernandes. We'll start him. If he doesn't impress me, we'll bring on Fred and McTominay. I'm not afraid to do that. And then we'll go top three of Anthony, Sancho, Rashford, I think. Because we do want the win. We do have to rotate as well because in 3 days, I believe it is our next game. So we will rotate a little bit as well for that. I think it's Crystal Palace, if my mind serves me correct.
Let's take a look at who the other teams are playing around us. Palace have Liverpool. Who does City have? City have Newcastle. Fuck it, we'll just switch it all on. Don't know why I pressed... I fat fingered the Y button there. Turn it all on. So, taking a look then at Vicarage Road, we've got De Gea in goal, Shaw and Wan-Bissaka as the fullbacks, Bella Kotchap and Varane as the centre-backs, Casemiro, CDM, Fernandes and Eriksen as centre midfield options. Fernandes, you really need to fix it up, mate, because you do get the assists, but you don't have consistent performances. So that captain's armband may be away from you by the end of the season, sir, but we'll give you another chance today. It is Watford, so I'm hoping for something. You're captain today, and we'll see how we go from there. Sancho off the left, Anthony off the right, Rashford through the middle, and it should be. We've got a strong attack. We should be winning this. It's only really a defence that we've rotated, and even then, it's not too rotated. So we shall see. But if we don't get 3 points, won't be happy. 6-1 Man City. Oh God. Yeah, we start in real life. We lost twice, so. As we come back, we lost 6-3 to Man City as well, and yet we're still with them in real life in the Premier League, so anything can happen. It can all change around. You've got Fulham up next. That should be a 3 points. I'm going to say it 3-1 United, because Mitro's difficult to play against, but I think you'll win that one. They've got some names that I recognise. Whether they'll do anything against me is an interesting one. João Pedro's a bit decent. But I'm starting to see a little bit why Watford are where they are. Tamid Abraham might be my best one yet, can't lie. I did accidentally help with it, alright? So I'll take part credit. But yeah, Tammy... What was up with Tammy in that last game? He hit the post from close range and missed his penalty. We'll give him a redo against Palace, I think, probably, purely because the December games are always needing rotation, but he didn't impress me. Although he's had a good season, so I'm not going to let one game of awfulness ruin him. He'll only win and gets about 6 or 7 games of awfulness, like what Bruno's been having, that I'll question him. And if we still had Van de Beek at the club and not out on loan, I don't think Bruno would even be sniffing the first team right now. But I don't want to call Van de Beek back early because he's actually having good growth out there. Sancho. Now, this should be a thrashing. Now, whether it is or not, I don't know why... Why is Bruno out on the... I guess because Sancho's in the middle, but Bruno doesn't need to be out on the left there. That's going to be De Gea's. Probably could use Lafont here again, by the way, but De Gea impressed me so much last game. I don't want to drop him again yet. Anthony should have Thomas here. Does. Eriksen. Rashford. Bruno. Oh, straight out of Koye. And you expected Bruno to be scoring that, really, didn't you? Maybe should have shot it with Rashford. He'd have put it in the back of the net. Shaw blocks it. Continues to block, and now Bruno can get it through to Rashford. Sancho's asking for it through, gets it through, but A, the run was bad, and B, the defending was good. Imagine if Watford actually get their second win against us. I will be upset, to say the least. Casemiro to Eriksen. Anthony. Overlap and run here by Wan-Bissaka. He loves them overlap and runs. He's going to try and find a ball in. It's not the greatest. Sierra Alta and Okoye comes together there. But it is the Watford goalkeepers. Casemiro wins a header. Rashford is trying to control this down. He does. Spots Anthony, who is onside, apparently. Oh! Oh!
marker. It's offside though, but I mean, that would have been a class fucking finish from Anthony.
I knew it was offside Rashford, but I thought take a shot anyway.
Barely, but it is offside against Marcus Rashford. Meanwhile, in an alternate reality, Rashford has scored past Fulham, made it 1-0. Nice one, Franco. Okoye. Bella Kotchap going to win that one. And I'm going to run straight into danger with Bruno. And of course, it's Bruno. Marcus Rashford, player to watch. We know that because he's scored. It didn't count, obviously, but he's made his mark.
Sancho. Watford are really going to have to just try and, I think, play for the... I mean, that's probably what they are doing. They're probably playing for the point.
We struggled a bit against Brighton. Watford might watch that game.
Because Brighton are also involved in that relegation scrap. 1-0 to Everton. That's the one game it tells me about. It doesn't tell me about the top teams, although I did switch them all on, so... Sancho. In for it to Rashford. We need a bit of option here. Play it back to Sancho and play it around, I think. Rashford, Bruno, Sancho, shots at Okoye. The move was smart, the finish was not. Bella Kotchap there again. Eriksen. Oh, I went to absolutely just shoot that from range. I'm going to try it with Casemiro. I'm not going to try it with Casemiro. I was going to go for another Casemiro long ranger, but the touch messed me up.
Making it through here, or they were. Good interception by Wan-Bissaka. Eriksen, poor touch.
Bella Kotchap, Casemiro.
I mean, it would be a big shock if Watford were to get something out of this match. And I don't want to be the team that gets shocked on, if that makes sense.
That doesn't make any sense. I know what I mean. I don't want to be the team to get beaten by Watford, is my point.
Good save, De Gea. Reliable as ever. Wan-Bissaka. Poor pass. It's thankfully bounced to Casemiro. It's not what I want to do with Wan-Bissaka, to be fair.
Jesus Christ, they're flying in. Watford are up for this, you know. Obviously, we've been better because we're better than Watford, but they haven't, like, just sat back and let us have it.
Which is a little bit annoying, to be honest, because I thought we'd smash Watford here. Move on with our day, but it hasn't been like that at all.
Bella Kotchap's there to close it down. 2-0 Olanga, nice one.
Sancho down the left here. Rashford's in the middle and it's locked onto Bruno. Why would it lock onto Bruno then?
There's a penalty saved in the Everton-Burnley match, for anyone's interested. That was the goal news there. I know you can't hear the goal news or the commentary. Fucking hell, they're going for it. Watford, can you fuck off, please?
Oh, Casemiro. Not the touches of dreams today. Not really been able to involve Anthony. Eriksen's gone the wrong direction.
Watford haven't been the better team, but they've not been bad either. Coming up for it, Rashford. Oh, I need some help. Just got too many players back.
Luke Shaw towards Anthony. Casemiro. Anthony. Oh, shoot, mate. I pressed the B button.
We're going to win the ball back just about with Varane there. Luke Shaw to Varane. Casemiro.
Just get the ball through, lads. Just get the ball through. You don't need to, like, piss around with it. Just pass it through.
Oh, fuck. Jesus Christ. Why is it always the bad teams that seem to turn up against me?
Anthony can't get it through. Burnley have equalised. They've got a lot of news from that game, not from many others.
For a brief second, I thought they'd put it in the near post. God's sake. What is going on here?
Tshabalala has seen out dining with Jordan Poole season for Valentine's Day. Want us to wonder, could marriage be on the way for these two lovebirds?
And it's 3-0 against Fulham. Nice job, Franco.
At least Fernandez is doing well for you. He's doing poor for me. That's going to be it for the half as well. Oh, man. We can't find a goal past Watford of all teams. Sometimes we'll have games where it's ridiculous amount of goals against teams. And some episodes, there'll just be a lack of goals. And this has been one of those where it's been hard to find the finishes today. We've only had two open play goals in this stream. And we've been going for an hour and a half. Rashford and Casemiro with the only goals today. I mean, the penalty goals obviously count as well, but two open play goals in an hour and a half. I'd click off and watch someone else. 4-0 Casemiro header. Fair enough, man. That's half time. Jeez, oh. Brighton and Watford turn into something special just against you. I know they do. They just turn up. It's only stupid teams that it should be easy to beat. Chelsea drawing 0-0 with Leeds. That's good. Go on, Leeds. Do something there for me, please. Crystal Palace keeping Liverpool at 0-0 as well. That would be lovely as well. I'm not going to complain about that. 1-0 to Aston Villa over Wolves. 1-0 to Brighton over Fulham. Arsenal also dropping points at the moment. They're not as much of a concern. It's 0-0 between them and Leicester. Newcastle 1-0 down to Manchester City. 1-0 between Spurs and Bournemouth. 1-0 between Everton and Burnley. And 1-0 to West Ham over Norwich. I think we drop down a place if West Ham wins, so we need to find a goal in the second half. But it has been very even. 63-37 in terms of possession, three shots apiece, and we've had slightly more expected goals, 0.9 to 0.7, but Watford, I've got to give credit to Watford's defence so far. They've been good. I don't think there'll be a shock win here for them, but getting a point would be a result for them. I know obviously we won't do much in the league because they've only got 6 points, but them getting a point here might just kickstart something. As much as I would like to be a charity case and give people points, I can't afford to. Anthony, Rashford, Bruno's through, Bruno's in, and Bruno makes it 1-0. And it was going to happen. It just doesn't matter when rather than if. And straight out the gates, we finally found our breakthrough. I think the break did both of, well, but especially us, did some good for us. Just regroup, rethink, and try and find a way through. And in the end, we have done. It's Anthony into Rashford. Bruno's making a perfect run. Just rounds the keeper. Taps it into the bottom right. A brilliant little finish from Bruno Fernandes. Even though it did go through his ankle, we won't question that. 1-0. Thanks to the Portuguese Magnifico. Happy Valentine's Day to Linnea, by the way. Tshabalala has my heart, but I'll never forget her. I haven't talked to her in a few days, so far. She's been busy quite a bit. Sancho makes it 5-0. Fucking hell. Fulham in the mud. We've got a goal. Can we win, please? Very much like that. Especially against a team with 6 points. Jesus Christ, what's happened to my chat? Rod's at FN. What is... Is that Morse code? Corner for Watford. In towards a Watford player. I thought Casemiro was going to win it, but number 31 caught it. I think it was Sinisterra or Seralta. Sinisterra plays for Leeds. I know who I'm on about. Ran to Anthony. Can he counter on his own? No. Gets absolutely caught with a brilliant tackle. Watford's road doesn't get any easier. They've got Arsenal next. Whereas we've got Crystal Palace, I believe. Fernandes through to Sancho. Takes it inside. Not quite like I wanted to be. Take it inside, took a shot on. Good defence again. And even against Watford, I don't trust just having a one goal lead. I'd like to find a second. Good interception by Wan-Bissaka. It was a heavy touch from the Watford player. We'll take advantage of that. Thank you. Bruno, Eriksen, Anthony. Oh, I thought Wan-Bissaka was going to continue his run. All right, we'll do a 1-2 there then, that's fine. Anthony going to try and turn us onto his left here. Back to Eriksen, Rashford, Bruno again, blocked this time. The passing play is very good, but the defending play is very good from Watford. Casemiro, try to go, a screamer. Caught in possession is the big Brazilian. Interception by Eriksen. He's been quite quiet today. He's been having a quiet season, to be honest. He's one that might be on the departures list towards the end of the season. Rashford is one that won't be. He forced a cracking save out of Okoye there. Casemiro out to, well, it was out to Anthony, but it's gone over his head quite a way. Riding our luck a little bit, to be honest. We've been, obviously, the better team. I'll say that many a time because we just have. We just are, and we always will be over Watford. No offence to any Watford fans. But they are causing me a bit of strife. I'd like them not to, to be fair. Sancho's got the pace on Gaspar, but he doesn't have anyone else as an option. Although Rashford is there now. It's a block again. Right, let's make some of these changes. Can't put boobs in the chat, mate. It's a fucking PG stream. It's not a PG stream. Because we're swearing a lot. But I get what you mean. No boobies in chat, please. All right, Fred will come on for a little bit. Fernandez, been slightly better in the second half. We'll keep the faith of them. And Kvaratskhelia will come on for Sancho. Corner United. Anthony, ball in. It has to be good. To Bruno! Oh, it's not going to find him. Fred on the edge of the area. Oh, I wanted to crack it with him from range. I wanted to see what happened, but it hasn't. Do we have the space? Casemiro. Wouldn't it have been a Casemiro screamer. It was nearly a Casemiro goal. Correct skill intercepts. Prevents the counter-attack. It slows it down a little bit anyway. Fred getting a hero's welcome by the away side. Man who put us through to the Carabao Cup semi-finals. Give us that chance to get it to Newcastle for revenge from last year. Fred into Rashford. He gets caught. Jury's out on that tackle. It probably was clean, but I'm still biased, so I'm a bit concerned. Wan-Bissaka intercepts, and now Rashford, who is offside. Realistically, though, what am I meant to do there? Yeah, clearly, but what can I do? Sierra Alta. Casemiro intercepts. Fernandez. Casemiro. That was for Fred. It works, though. Oh, it doesn't anymore. It would have worked if it had gone to the fucking Anthony. Still try to close it down. Not allowed to. Good interception by Varane. And a lot more defensively heavy than I thought it would be. Can't lie. When I saw the calendar and it said Watford, I was like, oh, that's an easy 3 points. Watford have made it anything but. Hopefully it will still be the 3 points. Runs to Rashford. Oh, he's closed down. Okoye, Fernandez tries to knock it to Kvaratskhelia. Back into Bruno. Blocked again. Sorry. No, but it got blocked. It got blocked. I promise you it got blocked. Unless it got blocked by Rash. It got blocked by Rashford, didn't it? Fuck's sake. Well, goal kick then. Nightis Bruno overhead kick. Fucking hell. We should do that for me. Where's my Bruno overhead kick? I've got Bruno the tapping merchant. Bruno the penalty merchant. Where's my easy win against the lower teams? Good block by Wan-Bissaka again. He's been solid today. All the right backs that have played have been solid. I mean, we've got good right backs at this club. It just shows. Anthony should win that. Does, and we'll get it away. Can we counter, please? Fred going to try and knock this over to Rashford. It finds him, kind of. Bardet gets in the way. Oh, fuck. Commit Varane there by accident. As in, I didn't know I was going to be controlling him. Good tackle, though. Fred gets it out to Kvaratskhelia. Rashford. That bursts the pace. Does not get him away from Sierra Alta. I thought it would. They've been defensively fucking sound. The reason we've only got one goal. Kvaratskhelia. Anthony. Why is he taking that on his right? Who the fuck tells him to take that on his right there? Why would that just take it on your left, mate? It's probably 2-0. Oh, fuck off. I've got a horrible feeling coming in. The horrible feeling is setting in. Anthony, Rashford, Can he find a goal, please? A goal, a game striker. A goal, a game striker. It's wrapped up. It's in the bin. Marcus Rashford. I don't know if there needs to be this many scenes for a 2-0 victory over Watford. But we're a very passionate team, all right? And Marcus Rashford, the fucking man on form, scores again. It's like real life. He just scores every game. And it is 2-0 at the near post. Manchester United will get the 3 points here at Vicarage Road, but boy, have they made us work for it. And I believe, like real life, he's not really in the Golden Boot race despite having 12 goals this season. Because Haaland has buggered off in the Golden Boot race. We'll show the stats at the end of the episode. This will be the last time I show them mid-season. Before the end of the series, before the end of the season, I'll show the top scorers and stuff. But personal Man United stats, like our player stats, I'm not going to show them now again until season's end. Is Rashford going to get another one late? I would bet against it. Oh, I would bet against it. That's great defending to close down Marcus Rashford. I wanted to slide there, but that's okay. We keep it alive. One more in us. What's Bruno done here? Has he tripped over? Just for the record, I want to say what my attempt was here. I'm trying to lob the keeper. I don't even know. Whatever. We done it. Right, we won. It was a tough one, but it's another clean sheet to add to the collection as well. And it's another victory. Tied to the pile, and hopefully, I doubt Man City drop points, and I doubt Liverpool drop points, but hopefully that shows that we're ready to push for the title. Breaking news, Rashford and Fernandes have been dropped. Fair play. I might do that with Fernandes this career mode as well. I mean, he did score, but my God, some of his play leaves a lot to be desired. Fernandes did get the goal just after half-time, and Rashford got the one to seal it just before the end. This is our World Cup. We've won it. Yeah, that's the season done. We've won the title. But yeah, it was always going to be our day. It was just a matter of when and not if. 58-42 in terms of possession, 14 shots to 3, and 3.8 expected goals to 0.7. Watford really fucking gave us the business, though, so some of our defenders deserve a good round of applause. But in the end, we do get the victory. Marcus Rashford, a goal and an assist and an 8.1 rating for our number 10. Whoever, since Tammy's come in, Rashford's actually been better than Tammy. in my opinion, anyway. It might just be a personal opinion. But Tammy's got a lot of contributions as well. It's a bit of a competition between them, I suppose. Wan-Bissaka, right back, didn't let that left side attack at all. Class of Wan-Bissaka. That doesn't really work. Varane was very good at centre back as well. Anthony off the right got an assist and a 7.9. Bruno found his goal, and even though he did get the goal, the rest of his play maybe left a little bit to be desired. Somehow got 100% pass accuracy, so I guess that's good. 7.7 for Bruno Fernandes. 7.7 for Luke Shaw. He was good at left back as well. David De Gea only had to make 2 saves today, but he made them, and it means that we get another clean sheet. Mario Gaspar was the home side's man of the match with a 7.8. And looking at Okoye, could have deserved a bit more in terms of rating, to be honest, because he did keep us out for the longest time. 7 shots on target, 5 saves, 2 conceded, and we do win 2-0. So taking a look then, I want to take a look at some of these Watford ratings to see where they're struggling. And I realise now that some of these ratings are not very good. I think they maybe need to strengthen if they can. Realistically, they're not probably going to stay up, I think. It's safe to say. They're on 6 points. Rashford was mid last season. The time we lit it up. This season, the time he's been kind of mid and Rashford is lighting it up. They aren't capable of playing well at the same time. I know, it's annoying. Fred only 5.9. Oh, God. Fred in the mud. Liverpool and City both won. I knew they would. But we won as well. We're keeping the race up. It's like real life, except instead of Arsenal, it's Liverpool.
I didn't see the Spurs result. I'm assuming they probably won as well, which means they'll have the same points as us still. Our quality made the difference, but they were fucking... They made us work for it.
I thought it'd be a nice little demolition job of Watford. Only a 2-0, which, I mean, it's still a win, it's still a clean sheet, but we could have more, I reckon.
We want to be consistent. And we want to end today with a win against Palace, but...
I get what we've seen from the other teams down at the bottom half. It ain't going to be an easy fucking feat. Brighton really made us work in that first game. Sanchez keeping them in it for the longest time. Watford, the defence from Watford there was class. They kept us quiet for the longest time.
I feel like Palace might be the straw that breaks the camel's back. I low-key could see us dropping points, depending on what team we pick. Inbox. Michael Dawson gets his loan offer finally. I've been waiting for this one to come through because I did a mistake with the other one. And he's finally gone from Zurich. Short-term loan. Because last time I did it, I did a loan to buy by accident. But I don't want anyone to buy Dawson yet. I want to see what he's capable of. And a youth player on settle. Billy Bishop. Unhappy with being in here. Just a little update on the youth squad. I've not been in here a little while. But Billy Bishop can come up. And we'll give him a loan out, probably. Maybe even sell. I don't know. 2-0 Casemiro. Jesus Christ. Who are you against now? I missed it. Newcastle. Yeah, beat Newcastle for me. I've done my head in career mode. Beat them for me. That'd be great. We still have to play them down the line as well. Where is the save option? These menus still hurt my head, even though I've been on the save for nearly 2 months now. Fred in the mud. He's just put in a grueling shift and bagged the winner to send us through. He's exhausted, still hurting. Came on to try to secure the 3 points. This manager doesn't deserve Fred. All right, if I don't deserve him, we'll just move him on. What's that say for the table, though, actually, real quick, before we go to the Palace game? It looks like that. Spurs did win again. My God, is it close. That's the halfway point of the season, by the way. So to get a big halfway point look at the table... Liverpool sit top on 43. Man City 1 point behind on 42. We're there on 40. Spurs on 40 as well. Chelsea 38. West Ham 36. Arsenal 34. Newcastle seem to have dropped out of contention a little bit. And that really makes me a bit happier because it's slightly less worry. It seems to only be the 7 teams now that will be battling for those top 4 spots. I mean, it's only halfway through. They still could come back. But I'd say 1st to 7th now are probably shoo-ins for those positions, and then top 4 before out of those 7, obviously. I'm hoping one of them will be us and we don't fall off a cliff. Taking a look down the table then. It won't scroll, there we go. Relegation zone, Norwich, Leeds and Watford. I think Watford are dead certs to go down by the looks of it. Hope Leeds go down. Please have Leeds go down, that'd be fantastic. And the other team I'm not really too fussy about, to be honest. But you do play Palace next year in 14th. They're only 3 points above the drop. So I hope we do beat them, but we struggled against some of the lower teams so far today, and I don't see that changing, really. Take a look at the news before we head in to the final game of today. Manchester United keep clean sheet against Watford. A solid display from Manchester United's defence saw Johnson's men keep a clean sheet against Watford and claim a 2-0 victory. Aston Villa, winners against rivals. Did they beat Wolves in the end then, I'm guessing? I'm assuming they played Wolves. Yeah, whatever. Don't care. Midfielders of the year. Somehow Fabinho's getting in there and Tshabalala isn't. This is fucking rigged. This week's star performers, we have Aaron Wan-Bissaka in there, Luke Shaw in there as well. The fullbacks doing the business against Watford. And Man United will be looking forward to another win if the 4-1 victory in their last encounter against Crystal Palace offers any clues as to which way today's result will go. We beat them 4-1. I do not remember that. But it's been a long season. And there's Wilfred Zaha. We'll be told that he was a former player of ours. It's the same message each time when you read this. I'm not reading it anymore. I refuse. When did we play them then? Because I've completely forgot. Maybe I've just put it out of my mind. When did we play Palace? It might have been way back when. It was the second game of the season. Well, 4-1 win there. And it was at Selhurst Park, so Old Trafford, hopefully we can get 5-1 win, make it even bigger. Fred to my bedroom, here we go. Full agreement with all parties, Tshabalala cleared the move, and all involved are said to be thrilled within the move. Jesus Christ. Franco's here taking Fulham apart as well, or sorry, Newcastle apart.
all popping off in chat. If you're watching this on YouTube, the Twitch link will be in the description. If you want to come in and join in the fun, you're more than welcome to. We're going to go for the one. The one striker seems to be working wonders. Today it will be Tammy. He'll get a redemption story here. I haven't really used Sesko or Makoko this episode. I'm going to sneeze. But yeah, I haven't really used either of them this season, this game, this episode. But at the moment, we can't really fit him in. I've pressed the wrong button. Well, we can't really fit him into the squad. De Gea could stay in because he's been great. Malasia, yeah. Dallo, yeah. Who have we got after this? Who do we have after this, actually? That will be my... That'll be how I pick this lineup. So I know we have a game on the 31st, which is only 3 days away. Or 4 days away. 3 days away. The 30th. Aston Villa. And then we've got... Here comes the fucking fixture fill up. Yeah, I'm really excited for this, personally. Probably get an FA Cup game somewhere in here as well. I forget the Carabao Cup semi-finals over two legs. So we've got to play Newcastle twice. The FA Cup's against Fulham, actually. There you go. You could see that. Before we go in, let's take a look at what the FA Cup's looking like. These are around three matches. I'm not going to read them all. I am going to read them all. Charlton, Huddersfield, Cheltenham, Swindon, Blackpool, Burnley, Stoke, QPR, Leeds, Sheffield, Birmingham, Forest Green, Sunderland, Liverpool. Come on, Sunderland. Back in the Sunderland boys in that one. Plymouth, Wimbledon, Barnsley, Man City, Rotherham, Cambridge, Palace, Bolton, Watford, Burton, Brentford, Wickham, Leicester and Aston Villa, Luton Town, Swansea, Oxford, Nottingham Forest, Blackburn, Millwall, Man United, Fulham, Reading, Wolves, Cardiff, Mansfield, Brighton, Walsall, Coventry, Derby, Everton, Chelsea, Spurs and Sheffield Wednesday, Hull and Newcastle, Preston and West Ham, Southampton and Wigan, Arsenal, Bournemouth, Portsmouth, Ipswich, MK Dons, Norwich, Middlesbrough, Bristol City and West Brom, Peterborough. Next episode, obviously, that will happen. I wonder how many cup upsets we'll get. Hopefully, we're not involved in one. But then again, we're against Fulham, so it won't be a massive upset. Fulham have beaten us in the past, I hate to admit. But now we know the round three of the FA Cup, that'll be a cup heavy next episode, I believe. It'll be Villa, then the cup games, and then one more Premier League game. Figure out the end of the episode, though. What am I trying to do here? One striker. Wake up, Marine. Come on. Diallo can have a run out. He's not had one yet. Fred and Tshabalala have to start. Fuck it, why not? We'll go Martinez, Lindelof, because they're the most fit fullbacks. I reckon that's how we run it. I don't reckon that's how we run it. Abraham can have a bench again. I'm still a little bit upset with him. Sesko can have a run out. I think we need another centre mid as well. Eriksen. Right. That is how we go for this match. Just change the captaincy. De Gea in goal, Malasia and Dallo as the fullbacks, Martinez and Lindelof as the centre-backs, Casemiro, CDM, Fred off the centre-mid side to the right, Tshabalala coming off to the left, Sancho left wing, Diallo right wing, Sesko up top. We've rotated a bit, so it might be a bit more of an issue this one. Alanga perhaps. I think I've got Alanga on the bench. If I don't, I'll put him on. I don't. Good idea. So that's how we'll look for this game. At Old Trafford, they're more or less fully fit. They've not got a bad squad. And their defence will probably give us trouble like they always seem to do. What are the other teams doing on today? Or are they even playing today? What have we got? No concurrent matches. Are we playing earlier because we've got cup games to come up? Whatever. We'll move into this game and hopefully... The plan is to secure three more points and keep us in the title race. But plans can often go awry. Final game of today's episode. It's been an up and down one, really. We've been the better team in most matches we played. We've won against Brighton and Watford, but not as convincingly as I would have liked. We've also beaten Spurs on penalties. And you can give Fred all the credit in the world, but it wouldn't have happened if it wasn't for De Gea also. Chat was super live today, enjoyed the stream, you know. Well, hopefully we can try and share it about a bit more, get a few more viewers, and it'd be popping off every time. I do love streaming this. And I do like some of the feedback I get on the uploads as well. I appreciate all the likes, all the comments, all the interaction as well. So if you like the streams, like the stream or follow. Do everything you want to this channel to help me if you enjoy what you are seeing. How's their bench looking? Because they're... I was going to say, why is Edward on the bench? Matessa is quite a good striker on career mode. I'm surprised they're benching Eze and Elise. When am I next live? It'll probably be Thursday. Thursday will most likely be the next day we do this. And it'll be another career mode. I think so far this Thursday will be career mode. I've got something to announce on Thursday about the rest of the weekend. So I will announce that on Thursday. And then... Walking Dead, the second game I'll start next week, I think. Just because I had a week break from it, and then we'll go back to it and get on the grind for that again. Because that was really fun during the first game, and I want to keep going with it. Dalo, early goal, please, for a change. You bastards. Casemiro. Oh, it's away again. Falls to Lindelof. Dalo. Diallo. Okay, that's confusing. Dalo and Diallo. Trafer makes a tackle. What time do you go live? It really depends. Because if I'm doing something in the morning, because sometimes I have to go out in the morning, it'll be 2 p.m.-ish UK time. But if I'm doing something in the afternoon, it'll be around 10 a.m. that I'll stream as well. So it kind of depends on what I've got to do in the day. But that's why the best thing to do is put notifications on and you'll see immediately. And you can click on it and say hello. Even if it's just a quick hello. Tshabalala, straight at Johnston. I should make a schedule, but it's just hard to make a schedule because I don't know what I'm going to be doing on a particular day. Good tackle by Fred there. Šeško can't pop it back through to the Carabao Cup quarterfinal winner. We get it with Martinez and out to Sancho. And Sancho is another one where I do like him and he's had good performances. But he hasn't had the assists or the goals to kind of back it up recently. Tshabalala tries a long shot. Gets fouled. Referee says nothing about it. Trafer. Oh, Lindelof. Oh, Lindelof? Did I not miss time? Did I not completely mess up that tackle there? Was that not a foul? All right. But Šeško out to Diallo. Oh, inside from Diallo. Good save. Sam Johnston. Did I not foul there with Lindelof? I'm so confused. But I've got away with it, so I'm not going to complain. And I don't know if Fred will be taking this one. Oh, he will, actually. It's an outswinger. Fred will cross this in. Full power. I'm going to try something here. Šeško, try to knock it down. Tshabalala! Imagine the day he scores a screamer. I mean, he's scored some bangers already, but the day he scores an absolute worldie is the day this chat goes absolutely ballistic. Šeško, Diallo. Diallo again, to try and find a ball in. It's away on this occasion. Can I switch to Fred, please? Ball through, on for Mateta. That should be Malasia's ahead of Ayew. Sancho out to Tshabalala. Sancho into Šeško. Try to find a way through. Maybe she just ran through and tried to shoot. But I thought I was getting tackled. Would have got tackled in the build-up. And I tried to lay it off. I think it was to Fred, who was the oncoming runner. Malasia to Sancho. Tshabalala again. He's getting involved, you know. I like that he gets involved. Plays for the team. Sancho. Cesco. Should have played that one more to Fred. I'm an idiot. I apologise profusely. Fred was in a good bit of space and I've shot with Cesco like an idiot. Good block from Lindelof. Mateta will get a second bite of the cherry. It's a good save from De Gea at the near post. Had to hold on. Sancho out to Malasia. Tshabalala. Sancho makes the move. Can he make the groove into Tshabalala? Cesco. Fred! 1-0. Oh, it's not 1-0. What? I was so confident that I scored there, genuinely. I even went 1-0. I thought we'd scored. I thought we'd put the... Wow. Well. I mean, realistically, he scores from those ranges on penalty shootouts. Can't do it in the actual game in open play. Interesting. Note that down on his CV. I really thought that was it. I really thought we'd take the lead with Fred, of all people. Madness at Old Trafford, as I don't use my eyes properly. Malasia takes it away, and we'll try and get it back to him. Malasia to Tshabalala. It's intercepted. I'm going to go. See you later, Franco. Hope you enjoy the rest of your day, mate, and I hope your Man United career mode goes well. And hopefully I'll see you next time. I'm glad you've enjoyed yourself. Ahmad in to Fred. Cesco's literally in open space. And he snuck it. This game is something. This game is absolutely something, I'll tell you that much. Benjamin Cesco scores what might be the weirdest goal I've seen in a while on this game. But it is 1-0. And that's all that matters to me. A hell of a pass from Fred. Look at this ping from Fred, by the way. Jeez, oh. I don't know how Johnson hasn't kept that out of his net. That's a class pass from Fred. Cesco tried... I think I was trying to lob it. I did press LB. It was meant to be a lob. Didn't get any of the height on it. It's just about snuck its way into the back end there. Another second goal in the Premier League for Cesco. He's not had a lot of Premier League time, though, so... I'm not going to complain too much at it. He's been class in the Europa League, so it makes up for it. But 1-0 United. Are we in that situation again? Well, we need to find a second to have that cushion. Cesco. Tshabalala intercepts the pass that was for Sancho. He's like, I'm taking this one on, sir! And he's put it wide. That's a penalty. Why? Because he's missed. Fred and Tshabalala thriving. God, I love this career mode. What other career mode would you see where someone actively plays Fred and a 55 rated player this much? Exactly. This career mode is consistent as well. It's everything you could want in a career mode. Fred with a chance. Saved by Johnston. You got the better using the best team in England, Manchester United, of course. You got some of the best players, such as Fred and Tshabalala. The youth academy's thriving, except for one player who wants out, which we've now promoted. Fred ball in to Sancho. Near post, it's cleared off the line. Sancho to Martinez. Diallo. And I don't think Casemiro kept himself onside anyway. But it hasn't found the big lump. The big lump of Brazilian. Mateta tries one from range. Tell you what, if that drops in, I can't even complain. Almost caught De Gea out. Diallo makes some space, but I don't know what he's making space for. There's nothing to play it to. Fred is there now. To Tshabalala. Try to find Sancho. It was meant to actually go to Cesco, but it was marked. Or I should say I wanted to go to Cesco, but it was marked. It made more sense. 1-0 up at the break, though. Fred with a fucking ping through to Šeško, which the pass was better than the goal by a country mile. Tshabalala's been decent as well. He did intercept a pass that was meant for Sancho, but beyond that, you know, they've been thriving today. I do love them, but realistically, I can't start them every game because we do have other players that need game time. I was never off the Fred and Tshabalala train. Well, I was off the Fred train, I'll tell you. Fred was on the train out here. But Tshabalala, I've always believed in. But Fred, he's proven me wrong each game he plays, which is kind of annoying. That, by the way, with Lindelof, was definitely a foul. That was 100% a foul. I don't know if I'll get to see it back, but that Lindelof tackle was not clean at all. 66-34 in terms of possession, 11 shots to 3, 2.5 expected goals, 0.4. We've been all over them. And this is what we should be doing consistently against the teams that are below us in like the bottom half. We should be just all over them, finding points against them, 3 points each time. And that'll be the difference in keeping us in the title race or us falling out of top four again. Because last year, we dropped a lot of points to teams that we shouldn't be dropping points to. This year, we seem to have fixed that problem with some new signings and some youth academy players that have decided to be the best in the world. Tshabalala is in, and he scored. Like, what? Like, I just don't understand how this man operates at this level when he's only 55 raid. Why is he so good? Tshabalala, brilliant finish. Šeško plays him through. He has to take on the defender, which he does perfectly, and he finds the bottom right. He's so good. Oh, I love this number. When I first got him in and for some reason gave him the number 7, I didn't give him the number 7, by the way, the game gave him the number 7. I was like, all right, this is the new number 7. This is going to be our star man. This is going to be the guy for the future. As a joke, I didn't think he was ever going to make it this big, but fucking hell. I thought he was going to do good down the line, maybe in the future, maybe a few seasons down the line. I didn't think he'd be this good this quick. But my fucking days, what a talent. Casemiro wins it back now. Malasia, Šeško again. It could be a second one for Tshabalala. He's not going to get there ahead of Richards, though Richards is a very fast defender. There's a bit of a struggle there by Johnson. Tshabalala will chase this down. He's not one to not chase things down. Martinez wins the header to Fred. Šeško. Fred. Tshabalala nearly through. I can't believe how good fucking Fred and Tshabalala are together when they're on the pitch. Like, it's so, it shouldn't work, but it does. It really shouldn't, and it really does. It's kind of annoying. Tshabalala outstrengths him, and now plays it for Šeško. Will we see a third here for Manchester United? Šeško is going to try and find the return ball. Tshabalala through to Sancho. He's offside, I think. The idea was there, though. I'm going to take my clothes off. Tshabalala, you are a star boy. My God, the support for this number 7 in this chat room is madness. If you're not catching these live, I don't understand it. It's always a party when Shabalala's around. Diallo to Fred. Casemiro. Tshabalala. Šeško. Back to Tshabalala. Oh my God, it's like fucking clockwork. It's just mental. It shouldn't work. Tshabalala gets another goal. Him and Šeško. I thought it was meant to be him and Abraham that were meant to be the partnership, but now it's him and Šeško that have decided we're going to fucking, you know, take over. My neighbour's just caught quite a show. I'm without gloves. Fuck's sake. I don't want to say it too early, but could Tshabalala get his first career hat-trick? Šeško. Tshabalala. Oh, it's just unfortunately got away from him there. Lindelof. Tshabalala can't get the touch to bring it down. Keeps the pressure on, though. You've got to respect it. Tshabalala again. Wants to take a shot on. The crowd wants to take a shot on. Šeško. Diallo. Oh, it's a save on that occasion. And bloody hell, the defender nearly put it into his own net. And you know what as well? We'll bring on Tammy. I know Cesco's been good today, but Tammy and Tshabalala seem to have a good understanding as well. Use my body, Tshabalala. Welcome back, Franco. You're missing quite a show here. The Tshabalala show. I think that might have to be the episode name. If he gets a hat-trick, we have to tie me down. Fucking hell. Fred's going to play it short to Sancho here, hopefully without getting intercepted. Teze. Diallo. Tshabalala from range. It's blocked by Martinez, I believe. Even Martinez needs to slow this boy down. Tammy going to use his physicality to not get the ball. Dallo does. Casemiro. Tshabalala. Trying to find Tammy. He wants to be unselfish, but can't find the ball through there, unfortunately. And problems have arisen because we have no left back. And Edward, it's good cover by Lindelof, and we'll get it away. Casemiro. I've tried to deliver that ball off, but that's a hell of a tackle. And it's not a clean one, but it is a hell of a tackle. I'm so high to cut bloody spell. Wilfred Zaha coming off from Michael Olise. Patrick Vieira needs something now. He has been done in by a 55 rated centre attacking midfielder from South Africa. Tshabalala. The Malasia now. Jesus Christ. This has been an episode and a half. Penalty shootout drama. Fred's, that's a red. Sorry. How is that only a yellow? So, not just because it's on Fred before we start the fucking Fred hype train. How is that? He's jumped into the tackle. How is that not a red? Man, that's nah, that can't run, surely. Get a better angle on it. Fred's trying to play for Tammy. And then Elise jumps in like that. That's got to be a red card. It's a life sentence. But it's definitely a fucking send him off kind of tackle. By no means is that just a yellow. I'm sorry. If that's a yellow, then I can get away with fucking anything. He's gone for murder. Minutes to go. Casemiro. Well, it was meant to go to Malasia, but he's run behind the defensive line for some reason, so now they're going to counter off it. That's great. Yeah, thanks, Malasia. You've really fucked me over there. And it switched off Casemiro. Okay. Well. The Lindelof foul in the first half doesn't look so bad anymore, that's all I'm saying. Yeah, look. Can't find the ball through to Tammy. Oh, fuck. Oh, fair play. So is the linesman flagged? When's the linesman going to bring up his flag then? I'm just curious. We're still waiting for it. I mean, it's not offside. I'm just annoyed. Looking back, Mateta's in line with Edward. It's a good play. But, you know, still, I'd like them to not have that goal because I like the clean sheets we get. But it's fine. We'll take the 3 points. It's a bit of a dampener on the day. Mateta does put one past us. We're not going to keep a clean sheet every time. First goal in 3 matches for Jean-Philippe Mateta, and he calls himself a striker. Tshabalala's got more goals in this game. Casemiro about to Tshabalala. Fred. Tammy. I'll try to hold out for Tshabalala to make the move in, but he just doesn't want to. He doesn't want his hat-trick, apparently. There's a tackle by Martinez. Good come to Sancho, despite the interception. Tammy. Tshabalala. I think he's out of gas, you know. I think he's out of gas. I don't think the hat-trick's happening today. It might happen someday, but not today by the looks of it. Casemiro intercepts, tangles with Martinez, and the ball is falling back to Palace now because of that. I think Tshabalala has tired himself out. It's been a long day for the man. 2 goals, another class performance. Save by De Gea, an easy save on that occasion. It's not where I've wanted to throw it in a million years. Why would I throw it to a player on the Palace side? Tshabalala out to Sancho. Tammy making the move. This is not... I didn't want to do this either. Okay, Tshabalala into Fred. What? He's fucking... Is that Diallo running offside like an idiot? Casemiro, Tshabalala. Can't find the ball through. Yeah, I think he's had his day. I think Shabalala's had his day. Hat-trick may have to come down the line. Down the pipeline at some point. Baha, it's in the middle of Martinez. I was going to just absolutely yeet that, but De Gea grabs it instead. That works just as well, you know, a little grab. Casemiro to Diallo. Tammy. Oh, pass the ball through. Casemiro, nice. Tammy. Oh, I tried to find Tshabalala and nearly found an own goal for Crystal Palace. Tried to play it off and it nearly went to its own net. We are going to win and it's got to be Tshabalala, man of the match. Sancho comes short again. Tshabalala. Crystal Palace winning the moment. And they're going to... Yeah, we're not going to get the hat-trick today. It was a great performance. Fair away, Martinez. God, those bounces just want to... Like, piss me off, don't they, really? We do win 3-1. The Tshabalala hat-trick. We'll have to wait till another day, but what a performance from our number 7, as per usual. You should expect it from him at this point. It's becoming less of a shock and more of a regular occurrence. The Tshabalala's going to have a good day on the pitch. Sesko and Tshabalala with a brace for us. Mitete again, one back for Palace. It was a good bit of build-up play to their goal, but try to get a clean sheet record. We still need 6 more or 5 more or something more, I believe. A certain amount of clean sheets we need to still get. I was about to try and find the... We'll watch this again, and not this, although the Tshabalala goal was good. I want to see how this isn't... I want people to understand... All right, explain to me how that's not a red. Just thinking back now, it's definitely something, at least. But whatever. Tshabalala, the man of the moment today. 15 shots to 5, 62 to 38 times possession, 15 shots to 5, and 4.3 expected goals to 1.5. We were always going to win that. Always get the 3 points. And despite Tshabalala getting 2 goals, man of the match goes to Benjamin Sesko, and I can't dispute that either. He was class today. Him and Tshabalala might be the next partnership to we go with, because Sesko was solid. Great at holding up the ball and playing Tshabalala in. And in the end, it worked quite a bit for a little while. Leecher once again getting his fucking ridiculous rating, which he always gets. 8.5. 8.3 for Sancho as well. He was trying to be creative as well off that side. Tshabalala with 2 goals and an 8. Fred also getting an 8 and an assist. I believe he assisted the Sesko goal. He didn't assist either of the Tshabalala ones, which doesn't quite make for the perfect combo, but it's close enough, isn't it? It's close enough. Taking a look at De Gea. A rare bad day for him, because he really shouldn't have conceded today, but he did concede. But we're not going to say too much about it, because we did get the win anyway. Shots on target 3, saves 2, goals conceded 1. Probably could have done a bit better, but it is what it is. Tammy getting a 5.9, but he barely had any time to do anything. So we ain't going to sneeze at that too much. James Tavernier was the man of the match, a former Rangers man for Palace. 7.8 from him. Mateta with a goal and 7.5. And Odson Edouard coming off the bench to assist that goal. And a 7 rating for him. Sam Johnston, 8 shots on his goal, 5 saves, 3 conceded. We do get the dub. And it's a good end to the episode. It'd even be better if some points were dropped from the other teams. And I think, actually, if the other teams haven't played yet, we'll be top. Of course, if the other teams have played already, we won't be top. But... What are your thoughts about your star man? Oh, even the media are buying into it. Even the media are buying in. Star man Tshabalala. Twice you beat Palace, you think you proved you got better players, or it's just that you've worked that way to play against them now. Well, we went 4-1 first time around, 3-1 second time around. We can't keep a clean sheet against them, but that's not important. Our attacking play is always a threat. It's the greatest day of my life. Future kids will have to sell for second. I don't see why Fred and Tshabalala can't be the starting midfield partnership. They're magic. At this point, I have to agree. I think eventually they might have to be. It's so stupid how it works, though. It shouldn't, but it does. I hate that this career mode has become about Fred and Tshabalala. I hate it. Tshabalala, yeah, Fred. I want him gone, and now I can't. I can't get him gone. Billy Bishop is happy to be in the squad. We'll try and find a loan deal for him. ASAP Rocky. I don't know if he'll get one very soon. Might have to wait till the summer, but we'll add him to that loan list. He's a cam, isn't he, if I remember correctly. Billy Bishop. We will send him out on loan. See what he can do. So that is that for today's episode. And by golly, what an episode. Where does that leave us? It leaves us second. Liverpool lost. Ladies and gents, we were in second place. That's, my God, what an episode. Top goal difference in the league. Most wins, most goals. Don't talk about losses. But, yeah, it's actually a title race. I could call it that now. I think I can call it that confidently, that we are in a title race. But the thing is, again, how close it is at the top, how close it is getting between, well, us and fifth now, I would say. 4 points separate us and fifth. We've got second on goal difference. If I'd not simmed, we would have been top for a few days. But, or at least a day, maybe. I don't know if our game happened later or what. No, it happened the same day, but we played first. We had the early kickoff. Chelsea beat Liverpool, which helps me a lot. City beat Brighton. Who does City play next? Leicester. We play Villa. We're in a title race. I can confidently say it now. Manchester City 45, us 43, Liverpool 43, Spurs 43. Chelsea 41, Arsenal 37. It's mad. This is gonna be some fucking second half to the season if we can win the Premier League season 2. I don't think we'll be able to. I think we'll fall short, if I'm being like really honest. But we're in a title race and I'm gonna give it my all. If I have to be realistic, it might not happen. But, of course, anything is possible. We've got Fulham in the third round of the FA Cup. Carabao Cup will be against Newcastle. And I don't believe the preliminary games have been played yet in the Europa League. We're still waiting on them being played. Fenerbahce, Juventus, Club Brugge, Dynamo Kiev, Trabzonspor, Dortmund, Lyon, Inter, Nice, Salzburg, Rennes, Arsenal, Basel, Rangers, and Wolfsburg, Porto. So we'll find out that as well down the line. I've got a chat message here. I'm playing pretty well lately. I'm feeling really good. I hope that means I won't just be on the bench for the game against Villa. I haven't played Makoko in a while. So I think if I do remember, we do have to start him. I think it's only fair. Makoko's not had a game time for a little bit. But what an episode, ladies and gents. A lot of greens in that month. Quite a good December run, to be honest. The only loss coming against Spurs. It could have been two losses against Spurs had we not won on penalties. But not a bad month. Kicking off today's episode, we took on Brighton and we just about got past them 1-0. My God, was Robert Sanchez trying to make sure we didn't get past them, but we did in the end, ultimately. And a 1-0 victory from Marcus Rashford getting the goal does the job for us. A 1-1 draw in the Carabao Cup quarterfinals meant a penalty shootout. We won said penalty shootout, and as Jordan will say, it was Fred who got the winning penalty. So the statue is still being built. 2-0 to Watford, or against Watford. If it was 2-0 to Watford, I'd be on my knees crying. It was 2-0 against Watford at Vicarage Road with a win there. And then we finished it up there against Crystal Palace with a 3-1 victory. Tshabalala, once again, putting on a show. And I don't understand. I don't understand why Tshabalala works like fucking that much. But he does. Love that more than life itself. Have a great afternoon, mate. Love to see more people tune in. Hope they continue to come back. I hope they do too. It's a fun stream. I mean, if other people are enjoying it, I'm enjoying it, ultimately. And that's fine with me. And that's fine with everyone else. And hopefully everyone is fine with that. So, to preview next episode, we'll be moving into the January transfer window. So, any ideas will not be definitely signed. I just want to make it clear. I will take a look. If I feel like they fit the team, if I feel like they make sense, I will make the move on them. We'll do three signings at most. And if I don't like them or I don't feel like they make sense, I'll still look at them anyway. I will absolutely look at whoever. If any shortlist options, I'll take a look. But if I don't sign them, don't be mad. It's just that I don't think they fit the team at this current time, which is fair enough, I think. But next episode, though, we will have Aston Villa at Villa Park. That'll be a tough opening. That'll be a tough, tough, tough opening. Following that will be two cup games. We've got Newcastle in the first leg of the Carabao Cup semi-finals at St. James's Park. That might be tough, although it is over two legs, so I'm not going to deep it too much just now. We'll then have our third round FA Cup game against Fulham, and of course the board wants to win that bloody thing, so we'll have to go all out for that. And then we'll finish off with another game against bottom of the table Watford. This time it'll be our ends in Old Trafford. And that will put us squarely in the middle of January with a big game, what will be a big game probably by that point, against Chelsea at Stamford Bridge to kick off Season 2, Episode 10. And if we do beat Fulham, we may get our fourth round game somewhere around here as well. So over the next two episodes, it'll be January based. Obviously, we'll take a look at transfers, take a look at possible moves in and moves out. Alanga may need a loan. Alanga made, I want to use Alanga more, but we've got Anthony. Again, though, we've got Anthony, who isn't doing great. And Diallo, who's doing all right. We've got Palestri and Soratiri out on loan. Alanga possibly could do with a loan out, potentially. But we've got plenty of right mids. Why isn't Mabry gone out yet? Or is he going out? He's going out when the transfer window opens. Okay, so a lot of that will go through next episode. But what I'm thinking for the right wing is we've got Anthony, and Alanga will probably always be back up, unfortunately, because Anthony is just cracked on this game. I mean, he's not been great this season, but he's just cracked in general. Alanga, I do see him in the first team plans. I think if I was to loan someone out, it'd be Diallo. And the reason I haven't loaned Diallo out this time around is because of the fact that the injury thing with Martial last year, we didn't have enough depth. Which is why I've kept Diallo around, just in case another injury happens to either Anthony or Alanga, or even both of them. Anthony or Alanga get injured. I'm joking. But in all seriousness, I've got plenty of depth on that side. I think we're okay with keeping Alanga in, but we may take a look at options. Someone who does need a loan is not Tshabalala. He's not going anywhere. He's up to 56 now, and he just keeps growing. By the end of the season, we're going to put him to Dynamo as well to work on his dribbling and pace a little bit. By the end of the season, it wouldn't be a surprise if he hits 60. And even then, keeps growing. Like, rating doesn't matter to this man. Of course, some of the loans as well. Donny van de Beek, I'm really looking forward to seeing how he comes back, seeing what he comes back like. He may be a new starting midfielder. Does he have 5-star weak foot? He does, yeah. I didn't know if you pick up on that. He does have 5-star weak foot. You are correct. High attacking work rate, 5-star weak foot. Will bust up the skill moves a little bit, get the pace going a bit, get his dribbling worked on, and hopefully some stamina as well so we can play him in more, even more games, if that's possible. And then we will work on the shooting and potentially down the line, I'm not committing to it, but potentially down the line we do a little bit of that. Oh my God. Is this a game changer? Do I do this? I know I said I wasn't going to commit to it, but if it only takes 4 weeks, do we give it a try? Do we give it a go and see what happens? The only issue with this is I believe he's absolutely tiny. He's 5'8". But at the same time, I think I want to try it now. I think I want to give it a go. I could always move him back. That is true. You know what? We've done it. It's done. It's going to happen. Tshabalala will transition to striker. We'll give him a few chances up top and see how he plays. Jesus Christ. How this episode has taken... This episode has taken a lot of turns. This is probably one of the best episodes I've done in a while. And I like doing every episode, obviously, but the most action, the most just like interaction, just everything going on. Everything is just popping off on this stream and it's mental. Just imagine Tshabalala at striker for a little while. The number 7 up front. Oh my God. This episode is the best episode ever in my eyes. It's the turnaround for Tshabalala. If he grows, by the way, imagine how many... I'm on the wrong hub again. I can't navigate this shit. I'm like a fucking fish on land. Can't navigate. If he goes to a striker, I wonder how much rating he would grow in. I don't know if he would grow in any, but with excellent form, it might be a bit quicker and it might grow a bit better. And then once he hits 60, we'll know his potential tag. And if he's got an incredible potential tag, this man could have the world. He already has the world. He's grown 4 ratings since the start of the season. Absolutely ridiculous. So, taking a look then. We already looked at the table. We already looked at the stuff. We looked at what we've got for next episode. We've looked at all that. Let's see how the player stats are then for the Premier League. Haaland sits atop the Golden Boot race, still by 4 goals ahead of ourselves with Marcus Rashford, but 3 goals clear of second place. Guedes from Wolves. We haven't heard a lot about Wolves, to be honest. I don't even know how they're doing. But Haaland on 16, Guedes 13, Rashford 12, Salah, Martinez and Paqueta on 11, and the double figures are coming from Bentancur, Jesus, Tammy Abraham and Phil Foden. Assists, Anthony is up there, but it's actually Tammy Abraham that tops the assists with 8 at the moment. 7 for Hwangi Chan from Wolves, 7 for Dwight McNeil, and there's a few on 6 here, including 2 Man United boys. We've got Burigo from Manchester City, Rashford from Manchester United, Olmo from Liverpool, and Anthony as well, of course, for the Red Devils. Anyone else involved in here? Ericsson in there, 4 and 14. Fred, 4 and 8. Clean sheets at the moment goes to Mendy with 7 clean sheets in 15 games. That's quite a good return. We're trying to catch up a little bit. De Gea has 5 and 18. I believe Lafont should have one now as well. I'm going to check the clean sheet objective real quick. And we'll see what we're looking at in terms of objectives as well. Yeah, 6 and 12. So we just need another 6 clean sheets. I say that as if it's easy. Clean sheets are fucking annoying to get in this game. We sold 3 players. At first I didn't think we'd go for the Premier League title. At first I didn't think we'd be able to, you know, make that move. But the way we're at right now, it's a possibility. Winning the FA Cup, it's going to be a difficult start because we've got Fulham to contend with. But if we get past them, it might be a great run. And Europa League, I think we have to win. I think we absolutely have to win. Last year I was focusing more on the Europa League. This year I'm definitely focusing more on the Premier League. Because if we bottle the Europa League, that's fine. As long as we get top 4. And top 4 is obviously the primary goal. But ultimately, if we can get a title race and low-key potentially even win the bloody thing. Who knows? Is there anyone else I want to call up from the Youth Academy actually right now and send on a loan deal? There's some great players here and there's some not so great players. We may have to... I think what we're going to do with Hancock is probably just sell him. So he stays in the save. He's 6'5", which is fantastic, but I don't think he ever will make the cut. Then again, I never thought Tshabalala would make the cut, so... But some of these players we need to decide on, I think, sooner rather than later. This guy, Lance Hartley, I think probably a move away would be good for him. We'll do a full Youth Academy thing at some point. I'll maybe do that off screen, what I decide to do, so we don't sit around for ages figuring it out. But to end today's episode, we'll take a look at the team stats. Hayden Fofana has gone up 8 while alone at Amiens. Fucking hell. Hayden Fofana has had a great loan spell so far.
Brandon Williams is doing all right at Montpellier. He'll probably go in the summer, to be honest. We've got good fullback options. Deshaun Bernard up one. Teren Mengi up one. Where's our next loanee? Donny up two to an 83. Zanik Bal up two to a 67. Jack Perry up three to a 65. Any more loan? Palestri hasn't gone up. That's concerning. Because Diallo has. And if Palestri doesn't come back with a better rating than Diallo, I think Palestri may have to go on a permanent, which will be a hard person to part with because I did want him to be a part of this. But if we've got better options, we've got better options. Choratire as well, only up one. He might go up a bit more. Garnacho's gone up four. He is definitely in the future plans. Thomas Moss, he's definitely in the future plans as well. There's too many players in the future plans. Thomas Moss is definitely going to be one to fucking watch. I'll tell you that much for free. Elise Petit's gone up four as well. He's been decent on his loan spell. And I think that's it for loan spells, except for Malangu, who concerningly hasn't gone up. And he is one of the ones I really want to succeed. Oh, yeah, shit, the stats. So, to end this episode then, I think most appearances will stay Martinez. He's absolutely clear of anyone else for appearances. Three clear of Sancho. And just, there's a reason he starts all the time. He's so consistent. He's so good. Goals come from Marcus Rashford, 15 goals in 20 appearances this season. 12 goals for Tammy Abraham. 7 now for Tshabalala. He's got 15 contributions in 13 games. 4-4 in the Premier League, by the way. Jesus Christ. It is madness what he is doing at this club. Šeško is 6 as well. Sancho and Bruno with 5. Mokoko with 3. Anthony with 3. Kvaratskhelia with 3. Fred with 3. Eriksen with 3. Elanga with 2. Dallo with 1. Martinez with 1. Laird with 1. Casemiro with 1. Diallo with 1. And Scott McTominay with 1 as well. As for assist, top assister goes to Tammy Abraham with 10. But in second place, it's that boy again. Tshabalala's in second for assists. What the fuck is going on? Oh my god. Nah, like, this can't be a Tshabalala career mode. This can't be a Tshabalala career mode. I don't... It needs to be a Man United one. Oh, fuck's sake. 6 for Anthony, 6 for Rashford, 5 for Eriksen. Mokoko with 4, Bruno with 4, Kvaratskhelia with 4, McTominay with 4, Fred on 4 as well, Dallo 3, Diallo 2, Casemiro 2, Sancho 2, Šeško 2, Laird with 1, Malasia with 1 as well. It just doesn't make any sense. More goals and assists than that fraud Bruno. And the most clean sheets, interestingly, come when we start Bella Kotchap. So that might be something to note if we want to go for the clean sheets. 9 clean sheets when we use Bella Kotchap. So, and he's only had 18 appearances. So that's a clean sheet every 2 games. I'm just saying, Bella Kotchap might be getting a bit more action than what he has been this episode. I love Varane's back, but Bella Kotchap, if he's fucking the one farming the clean sheets for us, and we need the clean sheets objective. That's all I'm saying. Martinez on 8, Anthony on 8, Shaw on 8, and McTominay on 8. And then we've got a few on 7 as well. Wan-Bissaka, Lindelof, that man again. Bruno was 7, Lafont was 7 as well. And I just don't understand. Also, can we respect this? Lafont, I mean, yes, 4 of them are coming to the Europa League against nobodies, but 7 clean sheets and just 11 appearances. If De Gea does fall off, we know someone who's picking it up. Because that's kind of mad. 7 in 11. He's got more clean sheets than De Gea has as well, might I add. Only 5 in 19 for Big Dave, but he's only really played in the Premier League. I reckon if he'd played in the Europa League, he'd have the same amount. But that's a hell of a stat. 7 clean sheets in 11 games. Tshabalala has more clean sheets than Casemiro. We might have to whack him at CDM after we've tried the striker plan. Who knows? But anyway, that is going to end what has been an absolute corker of a career mode episode. One last look at the news. Tshabalala next brace as Man United grab win over Crystal Palace. Tshabalala got his name on the score sheet for Manchester United in the 3-0 win against Crystal Palace. Man United's win run continues. Manchester United fans will be delighted that the team continues its winning ways with a 3-1 win over Crystal Palace. We triumphed over Crystal Palace. Vieira unhappy. Two of the teams fighting to get to the top of the table met, and it was Manchester United who emerged victorious against Crystal Palace. They'll hope the win will be a springboard to get off on a run of form in order to close the gap at the top. Respectfully, I don't think Palace will be looking for European football. I might be wrong. I might be wrong. It might be what they're going for, but I doubt it somehow. We've got Villa next. And this week's star performers. Somehow, Tshabalala doesn't get into it. And I've realised why he doesn't get into it. And that's because that was the game before's performers rather than that one's. Billy Bishop isn't surplus. It's to give him a chance. Why do you say it in such a dickish way? Where's the team of the week this week? Where's Tshabalala? Where's my team of the week? We need to find the team of the week. Scour for it. Shabalala's in it anyway, probably. Should be anyway. Sheshko will probably be in it as well. He got a 9 rating. But that will wrap up an incredible episode of the Manchester United Career Mode. If you guys have enjoyed, of course, if you're watching on Twitch, don't forget to follow the stream. Turn the notifications on. And we do these every 2 days. So it is consistency. It is fun each time. It's so stupid that we've got a 55 rated player outperforming most of the squad, but that's just the way it goes. Sometimes you find a gem, 56 rated now I should say, sometimes you find a gem and he just absolutely outperforms everyone else. But as well, if you watch on YouTube, I wouldn't mind if you left a like, comment, subscribe. If you have any ideas for January transfer signings as well, we'll be entering the transfer window. We've got a couple on here, a couple I need to remove as well, but we've got a few ideas on here already that we'll take a little look at. Not necessarily sign, but we'll definitely take some time to look through them. And again, anyone to add to that list, more than welcome to add them, and I'll take a look 100%. But I hope you guys have enjoyed, and I will see you next time for more chaos, I guess, at this point. I don't know what the fuck to expect, and I can't pretend that I can tell you what's going to happen, because it just, the career mode changes every time, every episode, and I bloody love it. I'll see you guys next time.